Yesterday, they played a tight-fought battle.
Right to the nose for three. And we're all tied. Can't afford to roll off. Gonna sit in time, and she will. Madaw will pick up the win.
Sherry Madaw came out on top, forcing a tiebreaker. 24 hours later, they face off again. The Olympic dream will end for one today. Kerry versus Madaw. The roar continues. Here's a look at the MTS Center in Winnipeg, Manitoba. The round robin of this year's Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is now complete in the playoff picture, looking very clear with a lot of teams with their eyes on Russia for the Olympics. Glad you're with us on this afternoon of curling. Brian Mudrick, Kathy Gauthier. And the round robin wrapped up on the men's side early this morning. It was a game a lot of people wanted to see. Two Olympic gold medalists in Kevin Martin and John Morris.
Well, it really broke open in this end, and John Morris talked a lot to Jim Potter about the deuce being there, thinking that the three spot really, really tough. They forgot who was throwing this final stone.
Jules Ochar, longtime coach of Kevin Martin, told me that he really sees that look of intensity in the old bear this week, and he is playing some fantastic curling, bat back and all. As we look at the action across the sheets this morning, big win for Kevin Martin, 7-6 the final there. What a nice moment. It was a standing ovation for Jeff Stout and Glenn Howard. Both their Olympic dreams come to an end, but a standing ovation from the crowd here at the MTS Center. This was a big game. Kevin Cooey knocked off Mike McEwen, and that meant John Morris was going to the semifinals regardless, and Brad Jacobs, what a run he's had. Perfect in round robin play, that 7-0 mark, and as you see, the top three teams now find their way into the playoffs. What does being perfect mean in round robin play? It means Brad Jacobs is now one win away from going to Russia to represent Canada. Kevin Martin, John Morris, they will meet in that semifinal Saturday at 2:30 Eastern time. Some business now still to wrap up, though, when it comes to the women's side. Of course, you have the tiebreaker today. I talked with Sherry Madaw just before this contest, and she told me this is the best that she's ever played simply because she's worked very hard to get here.
Well, she's tied amongst all skips with Jennifer Jones for the top, and she is the best drawer on ice that folks have found it a little bit difficult to draw on. That is huge.
You talk about that draw weight. They made a crucial mistake in the eighth end to let Kerry back into it. But what does a good skip do? She bails out her team.
Well, she does. And if there's been criticism of Sherry Madaw over the years, it has been her inability to finish off towards the end of the week. This one looks a little bit heavy, but Sherry makes no mistake. Great judging from the sweepers. She makes it for the win.
A beautiful shot, and that set up indeed a rematch now of this tiebreaker. And of course, the winner goes on to the semifinals. Chelsea Kerry would love a do-over, and she gets one, of course, today. She told me after that loss to Jennifer Jones, it wasn't a really big deal for her team because it was Jennifer Jones, and she has rebounded nicely.
Well, it was also the first game against Jennifer Jones, and this Chelsea Kerry team can be very, very good. They've got a great coach in Dan Kerry. They have some depth. They played on the circuit, but there's one sheet out there today. Their inexperience at playing at this level is going to be a factor today. They have to focus on the broom and the rocks, not the outcome.
The tiebreaker is next. Madaw, Kerry on TSN.
This is a once in a lifetime. I mean, to play in front of a home crowd in a building this size, especially in women's curling, like for the men, the Brier is in an NHL-sized arena. We don't have that. The Scotties is in a smaller arena, so couldn't be more excited to be playing at home in Winnipeg. Just, I can't, too cool to describe.
Especially when you're in this venue and you see the Olympic rings everywhere and the media is asking you questions. So it's hard not to focus on kind of the big picture. But I think with everyone's career kind of wrapping up, it would be a dream come true.
The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by Tim Hortons. Always fresh, always great tasting coffee.
We're about to kick off a very exciting weekend of curling. It begins with this tiebreaker. It's time to meet the teams, brought to you by Ford, proud partners with the CCA for 20 years. Sherry Madaw has been so impressive. Her team from the Coldwater and District Curling Club in Ontario lead Lee Armstrong, second Lee Merkinger, and third Joanne Rizzo. They are the team from Winnipeg. They'll have the crowd support this afternoon. Chelsea Carey, her lead is Lindsay Titheridge. Second, Kristen Foster. Third is Christy McDonald. And they curl out of the Fort Rouge Curling Club in Winnipeg, Manitoba. Thanks to skill-based points throughout the week, it is Sherry Madaw that got choice of rocks, and she chose the red stones. Carey will have the yellow stones. Now, in the tie-breaking format, they do draw to the button. It was Sherry Madaw. We talked about how good her draw weight has been. Madaw's team has Hammer, and a kick us off on this crucial Friday afternoon is lead Lindsay Titheridge.
And in the tie-breaking format, teams do not have choice of stones from another sheet. They must play the stones that are on the sheet, so sheet D stones. Both teams have played two games out here, both throwing red and yellow, so they've had a chance to utilize these stones.
Okay, 10. Are we hitting it?
In talking with Sherry, Kathy, just before the game, there's so many fine details you look at to be successful throughout the week, and she looked at the rocks on the sheet, both the red, the yellow, the record with both stones. And she told me basically that the record with the yellow stones, not very good in women's play, and decided to throw the red. A lot of confidence in these red rocks. And how big of an advantage is that, Kathy?
Well, it's a confidence thing for sure. And when you look at the numbers in women's play, in men's it's much more equal, but in women's the edge absolutely goes to the red rocks. So there have been seven times they've been out here throwing them up and down, and it has been the Red Rock advantage. Six times Red Rocks have won, and only one yellow. In the men's, as I say, it's 4-3, but you got to go with something like that with confidence. Plus, on top of that, Sherry did win with red when she played on this against Val Sweeting. And Chelsea Carey's lost with the yellow stones when she played Stephanie Lawton. So Sherry Madaw looking for any edge, not only for herself, but maybe to get in the head a little bit of your opponent as well with the stones.
Same weight.
Okay, easy. Right, easy right on this one.
Lee Armstrong leads stones for Sherry Madaw.
Whoa. Can't.
No.
Not quite yet. No.
It's trying.
No.
Okay.
So, Kathy, this a rematch of the final round robin game that Sherry Madaw won to set up this game today.
Well, and so you go to school a little bit from the week as well as your game against the opponent. Sherry Madaw has been so good with the draws, so make sure you keep that 4 foot open because that is what she needs. And for Chelsea Carey, maintain your focus. This is not outcome, this is a game. Key matchup today, I think, will be at the third position.
The game plan brought to you by World Financial Group, helping families have better financial futures.
All there, T-line.
I saw Kristen's numbers at 80%. That's not bad, but in this field and the strength of the field, she is eighth amongst the teams.
Hold on. 13-9 should be pretty close.
That's a huge edge because her opponent today is tied for first. Lee Merklinger having a great week. And there's those great numbers that we talk about with Lee, and that's a little bit why I think a lot of the focus may be on the thirds, not only what they give in terms of emotional support, but when you have somebody who is tied for first and somebody who is in eighth, the degree of difficulty of the shots as they move up the line to the third position can really make a difference, and Lee is helping Sherry with that very much.
There's a spot there to go.
Yeah, no, it's
okay.
Just normal.
Kathy, so many great teams, curlers out of this province, out of this city over the years. We saw that great moment, Jeff Stoughton, the standing ovation, even other teams across the sheets clapping and showing their respect. I find it bizarre, and now, of course, this Carey team is Manitoba's last hope. No Manitoba team has won the trials.
No, I mean, Jeff came close the year that they lost to Brad Gushue, but it just goes to show that even though that there's some strength, four Manitoba teams came into this field. We have Jennifer through in the women's side to the final. Chelsea, a great chance by being in this tiebreaker to move forward, and two great men's teams, but that shows you the depths of the field at the trials.
Yeah, clean on this one. Clean
it. Wouldn't that be something on the women's side, an all Winnipeg battle?
Well, the crowd in this province would certainly like that.
Yeah, got the nose.
intro. Very nice wait.
So in Carey's last hope for this cycle in a must-win game, a very open end continues. Of course, Madal has hammer here in one in this crucial tiebreaker.
You really wouldn't expect anything different. They did not play on the final draw last night. That was a men's draw. They did not play this morning. That was another men's draw. And so it's a little bit getting all those nerves and that extra adrenaline out. And it's also testing the ice a little bit, given there's only one sheet for the very first time.
Guys,
there's the sheets that were.
More than me.
9.5.
Yeah.
Okay. Up a bit. Easy then. Easy.
No. 9.5.
No.
Here it comes.
This one's coming up. Yep. You can go, Army. You can
roll.
Go.
Joanne Rizzo makes the hit.
Doesn't really matter, does it?
Joanne very strong on the draw side, tied for second amongst all, not so strong on the hitting side. So if you're going to play to her strengths for sure, like Sherry Madaw, the draw game.
Christy McDonald, third stones for Team Carey. She had a very interesting start to the trials, and by interesting, I mean terrible, because she was very sick and could not play in the opener against Jennifer Jones, but has rebounded and playing well for her team now.
Throw.
I can't imagine how bad that would feel. You work 4 years, so hard, train, compete, get to this moment, and can't even play in the opener.
Well, and you have to make those decisions as a player, as Christy did, whether you in fact decide that you've worked so hard you want to play, but what you wind up doing is hurting your team because you're just not physically in the best shape. So glad to see her back and able to play with her team after working so hard to get here.
Line looks good.
Yeah, it's not moving, guys.
Tons of room.
No.
No, it's still back there.
Back eight.
If you can. Oh, easy.
Yep. Nice weight, Joe.
Well done.
Yeah. A good weight, just hoping it would finish a little bit more.
It's too bad we could have come to either one.
Okay.
It looks like it's...
Yeah, I'll just throw normal. Gosh. Play a little flop. It should come up
might
here.
Might be in.
Okay,
just touching a piece of that block out line.
If it's not moving, then sweep for the double.
Okay.
Just pull up half a rock.
Chelsea Carey, Kathy, one of many in this building, including you, to my right, massive Winnipeg Jets fan. She couldn't believe that she was going to be curling on the same ice surface where she watches her favorite team and was really excited. You heard her talk about it off the top of the show. Women's teams don't usually get to play in an NHL-sized arena, so this was going to be so special for her and really making the most of it so far.
Well, it is a really nice opportunity to play in a building this big and to have a lot of local support.
9-3, 9-5.
And to that point, Kathy, a lot of times they play in those spiels in the cash circuit, but they're on the road a lot. So to be home and have all that family and friend support is huge as she makes a hit and Carey lies one without.
And a very nice shot too, because she's rolled in front of those two stones, so it's not as easy to get rid of as you might think. And so Sherry Madaw is just going to draw.
It's really close.
Right here then.
Okay, two lines, but
that's less than you. On the other side of the line?
Just a little bit, yeah.
Okay. 95.
Yeah.
Did you get on mine?
14-1.
Kathy, you never think of blasting at this point. Is she just saying, all right, the force is on and I might have to take my one here? You'd never think about trying to blast a bunch of rocks out?
Well, you can, but if you make the blast, you're rolling out, and Sherry Madaw sees an opportunity early in this game to maybe generate an extra point.
95.
If you do blast, you are not sticking around. And there's those great numbers.
Line's really good.
Line's good.
Gotta go.
Yeah.
Line's really good. tight, actually.
Gotta go hard.
Line's really tight.
Right up. All you got.
Just full
Lee
12.
And Lee with a big scrub. Sherry's front end.
Right up. Right up. Right up.
Losing line.
Keep going.
Keep going. Tighter. Okay, that's
good. It'll find the paint, but that is not shot stone.
Tough one. Sorry, guys.
12. Okay, you get the next one.
Well, Brosh, it wasn't the weight that was the challenge as much as they were losing line almost right away.
Yeah, it's got to be full 12.
Yeah.
Do you want it to backish?
Even if we can. I mean, yeah. I don't think I'd like it back so that her hit and sticks a little harder, but not a big deal. Just
like 95 then.
That should be good.
That's about what I threw.
And they so more than practice. I was throwing 15 in practice, 10, 15.
Yeah, just a little more. Okay. 95.4 is close. Back 8, back 12.
Kathy, for us not familiar with all those numbers, what are they talking about when they spit out those numbers?
Well, they're talking about a number of different things. They were talking about hog to hog. I timed Sherry's and it was a 14.8, and that's a little bit slower than we have seen some of the conditions as they go on. And they also were talking about intervals, so back line to hog line, suggesting that a 3.95 split would get her there. Wants to split the house and make sure to force Sherry Madoff.
Go, 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 go. Very nice. Good shot. Good shot. Okay, nice roll.
So with her final stone here in one, Sherry Madoff drawing against two in this tiebreaker.
What was that one that I threw? I don't know.
14.
So that's like 14.
Okay.
And now just throw an odd on.
Yep.
Yeah, like practice.
Show me T-line.
Now you can expect that this path actually might be quicker than where Sherry threw the first time, keeping in mind that when the teams practice for the game, they each throw 8 up and 8 back. A lot of the play is outside to the middle.
Line's good.
Seven.
Go T, show me T. Line's great. Easy, ladies.
Clean it. Easy.
Line's great. T line.
Breaking now. Yep. Right to the T line.
T line's good.
Gotta go.
Merklinger, Armstrong.
Gotta bite the four.
With a nice brush and Sherry Madoff. Very nice draw weight.
Nice sweep. One red.
Good. She'll bite the 4 foot for her single. And a 1-0 lead in this tiebreaker Friday matchup.
Thanks.
The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best. By Capital One, what's in your wallet? And by Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for 20 years.
There are four teams with the loudest cheering sections here in Winnipeg. Jennifer Jones, Chelsea Carey, Jeff Stoughton, and Mike McEwen are all very happy to be playing at home, and they're all trying to change something that's rather hard to believe. No curling team from Manitoba has ever won the Olympic trials. There have been winners from British Columbia, Alberta, Saskatchewan, Ontario, even Newfoundland and Labrador, but none from here in Manitoba, a province with as rich a curling history as any other. But they have been oh so close. Kerry Burtnick was the runner-up to Kevin Martin at the 2001 trials. 4 years later, Jeff Stoughton had his chance but fell short to Brad Gugu. Yet despite being on the top step of the podium at so many Scotties and Briars, it's never happened at this event. Now Manitobans have a history of Olympic success on other types of ice, and the people here in Winnipeg would like nothing more than to see that continue, but on the curling ice in Sochi with a Team Canada that's their very own.
Mike McEwen will likely have another chance, but as we saw earlier today, Jeff Stoughton, Briar champion, world champion, the one thing missing from that resume representing Canada at the Olympics, it's not to be for the men's side. However, on the women's side, there is definitely life. Of course, Jennifer Jones waiting in that final. In our feature matchup this afternoon, this tiebreaker, it is Chelsea Carey down by one with hammer and a chance to move on to that semifinal tonight.
All right, girl. I like this, Merck.
Well, she's got her two corner guards set up.
Right here.
Nine and a half.
Roll it on.
What's the call?
9.5.
9.5, guys.
That one yellow guard too close for comfort for Sherry Madonna. The highlight's a very splittable stone. That's why she's asking Lee to remove it and roll back towards the center.
Right. Wow. Yeah, that's good. Okay.
Kathy, both these teams with 4-3 records, and both teams got here differently.
Well, they really did. Look at that stretch. She starts off with a great win and then loses three. But if you take a look at the teams that she lost to, Jennifer Jones, Rachel Holman, two teams that still wait ahead for Sherry Madov if she's to advance. And that will be a psychological thing as well if she's able to move.
Look at those final three games too. 7-6, 7-6, 7-6. And we showed you that final draw she made, as Sherry certainly has brought her A game this week.
Well, and what's really good for Sherry Madov is that with those three wins, she's finishing the week on a really good momentum swing. Plus, because they were so tight, you get used to having to just stay very focused for the entire game. There's no let up, and that's only going to help her.
If you believe in stats and momentum, according to this, Chelsea Carey should win her next two.
That would be the theory. And we talked about that Jennifer Jones loss, first game in this big setting against a very strong team, and won a couple, lost. What that says is she is able to bounce back, play hard, loses very, very tough. And mental toughness is a huge part of this game. Chelsea's certainly showing that she has that so far this week.
There can be, Kathy, if you let them creep in, a lot of distractions. I had a chat with Chelsea before the game, and she basically sent out her own press release before this one to her family saying, listen guys, I love you, come watch, here's some tickets, but please don't expect a lot of my time this week because you know what we're focused on.
Well, and it's tough, and I think that everybody's family and friends of all of the women and the men that are in here only want to help in every way that they can, and especially playing in their home city and their home province. There are so many more people around that just want to wish you well and talk to you, but you do need that alone time. You do need that space to concentrate and to recharge, and it's good to say that up front so that people don't wonder what it is that they can do to help you. You've told them what they can do.
One family member didn't need tickets because he's got a pretty good seat, and that's Dad, Dan Carey.
Well, he's fiery. I remember back in 92 with Wilf Peters, or rather Vic Peters, playing third. He was always the emotional guy on the team. Great shot maker, but Chelsea's definitely got his spirit.
Go. What you got?
Okay. All right.
Joanne Rizzo will leave that one by the Tim Hortons Cup, and there's the move to go around.
No, I wish it wasn't
so
tight.
It's about four, huh?
Yeah, four, five.
Yeah, I got 12
on
yours.
Four. So, Kathy, after an open end here now, a possible chance for two?
Okay.
Well, it's a great chance to get around that corner guard for sure for Christy.
Yeah, top eight.
Christy used to be called Christy Genyon, her father Bob Genyon, an accomplished Manitoba curler.
Close and not deep. Not deep.
Very close. You might have to go for line.
Line only.
Line only.
Very close.
Close.
You're okay for now.
Line only.
Top eight, T.
You're okay.
T line. T
line.
Close.
T line only.
You're
okay. Higher.
You're by.
It's T. Deep.
I think it's back a little bit.
Whoa. All the way back here.
No. Okay. Good.
And that will be the low and shot stone back eight.
Remembering the first end was all hitting, and so it really is now getting a feel of draw weight here in two. Draws. The edge at the third position is definitely to Joanne Rizzo.
No line!
Just seven.
No.
Okay.
All on its own. Great.
Well done, Riz.
So that being said, Kathy, if you look at those numbers, and I'm assuming teams do, and you see maybe one player and your competition is struggling in a certain area. Can you expose that, or does the game and what's happening dictate that more?
It's a little bit of both. Obviously, you're not going to, in that situation, she's going to play the draw. But if you know that a player like Joanne Rizzo is a much stronger drawer than a hitter, you can dictate your style of play, although you usually tend to look more at the skips to see what you want to force them to do.
Right to the corner, yep.
Hard!
Line's perfect.
Let it go!
Line's perfect. Go hard.
Line's great!
Go hard!
Kristen Foster, Lindsay Titheridge, the front end for Carrie's team.
Easy, easy, easy.
A tiny little bump, but Carrie does lie one.
Sorry.
Had a girl face.
Okay. She's just a... Now she just go, go, go.
Like a nine?
Yeah. Got to play it kind of tight to the guard, though.
Yeah.
Just want to get it on the outside nine. Right there. That you forces red there. Good. Yellow goes there. So you would expect to see nine. The yellow go this way, the yellow go this way, and potentially two red stones remain.
Nine, please.
Kathy, you got your stats sheets nearby?
I'm surrounded by them. What can I do for you?
Excellent. Just curious. We've talked so much about Sherry's draw weight. How's she done with the hits this week?
Okay.
She is sixth ranked amongst all players in terms of hits, but you have to remember that at the skip position, that more often than not is not a wide open hit. It's a very complicated situation like this.
Sherry Madaw with her first two and two.
Clean on me!
Clean, hard, make the hit, and both yellows spill. Usually when they're debating, it's close, and that shot is great.
Well, the curl's just that wee little bit more. She makes thicker contact, and that red one that just rolled out is also in.
We just got by the guard. Wow. I thought that was in my voice. Yeah,
like we just got by the guard.
Stay.
Yeah.
Good shooting.
Thanks.
What do you like? Am I the other turn, Cage? No, in turn. Yeah. Are you a little flip there? No, it's out, but it's we can roll right on top of it if it's not moving.
No, I think it'll.
Kathy, Chelsea's never skipped at a Scotties, but as we talked about, a lot of experience with the slams and traveling and playing. For those of us or the nation watching that don't know a lot about her, what kind of skip and what kind of team is this team?
Very determined, I would say. Very aggressive. They like to play a lot of rocks. They're very, very committed to the sport. This is the beginning of what you will see of this team. You can expect for sure from Chelsea to see her, I would suspect, at a Scotties one day.
All right, Chelsea, that's fine. Okay.
Nice little shot to line one.
Problem for Chelsea is she lives in a province where Jennifer Jones also plays, and only one gets to advance.
I think Mike McEwen's had that problem for a number of years as well. Okay. Okay. Jeff Stelton success. Role,
right? Yeah. Just watch the finish.
Yeah.
It's a new spot. I like a nine here.
You can see that stone is exposed on the outside. We haven't really seen a lot played out here outside in. This is that tricky part of sheet D. Although as the game goes on, we often see that there's challenges more with the draws than with the hits.
Sherry Mada, the intern hit.
Got the nose.
Good. Nice shot.
And the shooter hangs on. That'll force Chelsea Carey to make a play on that stone, edge 12 foot.
Thanks. Could have taken a little less ice.
Fathers and sons and mothers and. No. Sherry's kind of just out there.
Yeah.
Anywhere on the high side. Like, as long as we don't get the nose, it's okay.
Yeah. Half rock or less.
Easy peel. 7/8, we still get it.
Yeah. Okay.
Peel. Easy peel.
Yeah. It's nice.
Final stone here in two from Chelsea Carey from the Fort Rouge Sherman Club here in Winnipeg. Peel weight, make the hit, make the blank, keep the hammer. She'll roll it away, and she is successful. It's Tiebreaker Friday here at the MTS Center.
I'm the youngest on my team, but we've really worked at perfecting our game and the things that we need to do to play at our peak performance level.
Kerviazzi, Weagle, called off. One, over, move in, and there they are! Three!
It's an unbelievable feeling representing your country, and something that I want again, and something that I aspire to do this year. It's something that I want to go back and get that gold medal this time and make Canada proud.
Jennifer Jones, of course, has that bye to the final. That was Rachel Holman talking about her dream to represent Canada. She's into the semifinal now. Madaw, Carey, Holman all had 4-3 records, but because of skill-based, it was Rachel getting that bye to the semi. And, of course, either Madaw or Carey would love to meet her there. And that brings us, of course, to this crucial tiebreaker here at the MTS Center. It was a blank in the second end. Sherry Madaw leading 1-0, so Chelsea Carey still has the hammer with action underway here in three.
You're good. Please. Very nice. Good. Nice throw, ladies.
Kathy, what are skill-based points or skilled-based?
Well, the players before every game have a draw to the button, and in this competition, each player from the team must throw at least one draw to the button, and then you can have anyone. If your lead is who you think is the best at throwing that draw to the button, after that you can have them throw them all. Typically it is the skips, and that
really
is because
hard.
They make that shot more often than not or need to, so it's a good test. And they measure the distance between the center of the ice, so there's a hole in the ice, and they measure the distance between that and where your rock stops. And they add those all up, and at the end of the week, they take a look at the least amount. So the closest you are to the pin, obviously the less numbers you have. And the lowest out of the three that you've just mentioned was Rachel Holman. And what a massive benefit that was to her and her team to move directly into the semifinal and not have to be out here playing in a tiebreaker. One extra game at this level is a lot.
Kathy, where were you in high school? With that kind of teaching, I would have been an honor student. That was fantastic.
Yeah.
Very well done.
I'm not sure that I could have worked with you.
Oh, come on. Anything's possible.
Yeah, my move good here, so.
I've had a few questions asked via Twitter and email and from friends. What happens if Rachel Holman were to win and go on to represent Canada at the Olympics? Of course, she's the defending Scotties champion. If Rachel were to win, Jennifer Jones would be Team Canada. Of course, Jennifer did lose to Rachel in that Scotties final.
Well, for Sherry Madaw, without Last Rock, not particularly concerned about playing a force game, is not going to take a lot of chances. And so if Chelsea Carey wants to play the hit game, she'll play along.
Easy. Yeah,
same weight.
Easy on this one. Whoa. Easy.
9.5.
Okay, you're good. Clean it. You're good. You got the nose. Very nice work.
Booty. Good shooting, kiddo.
You want the same or a little less?
A little less.
Another open end here, Kath. You've watched both these teams. Is anyone more aggressive than the other?
You know, I think that both of them are kind of waiting. It's a little bit of that you go. And obviously, Sherry Madaw with Last Rock Advantage had not counted on taking one. Your goal is to score the deuce. And with that one, I think that for Chelsea Carey feels that she can afford to wait.
Okay,
that's fine.
9-2.
Like halfway?
Talk to Hans Wuthrich before the game. Hansi is the ice maker that has worked so hard this week. Yep. And I asked him if he thought the conditions would be any different this afternoon with only one sheet in play. We're right against the boards. He doubted it very much that it would be. In fact, if anything, he thought that the conditions would be better because it is colder, the pebbles more crisp. There's not as much air movement. He doesn't have to worry about bringing in any air on the on sheets B and C. And that's often where it gets the warmest in this building. So hoping for good conditions right through.
Just by right before.
And they really have been for the most part this week, except for the outside sheets on the outside half. Sometimes we've seen some very strange things happen.
Good. Nice white.
There he is, one of the hardest working men in the building. He's got a great talent surrounding him, but he is the brains of the operation that really does direct and ask for certain things if he thinks things need to be fixed.
And he has already qualified for Russia.
He has. He got his qualifications to go to the Olympics.
Sure
he will be doing it. And, you know, you talk about Hans and the kinds of interesting things he did. Last year when the World Juniors took place in Sochi and he went over there, he was concerned because the building was not full. And he didn't know how he was going to find out what would happen in the Olympics when the buildings will be full. So he paid people. They went out and they paid people, 500 people, to come into the building just to get a sense of what kind of heat they would bring in, what it would do to the airflow, all of those kinds of things, because that is his craft that he takes pride in and wants to make sure that at the Olympic Games, the ice conditions are spectacular.
Got the nose.
Another hit on the nose. Kathy, a lot of these teams obviously throw it a long week. They have routines and they stick to them. One that I found interesting, talking with Lee Armstrong and Joanne Rizzo. In the morning, they'll actually have an ice bath to help wake themselves up. And I said, why don't you just walk outside? It has been a very cold few days here in Winnipeg. And obviously, it's not a far walk from the hotel to the MTS Center. But I wake up in a hurry as soon as you step outside. But stick to your routine, I guess, right?
Whatever your routine is, it's extremely important that that is what you stick to and you don't deviate. Ah, you guys are whips. This is only the beginning of winter.
For the record, I did live in Winnipeg for 2 years, and I grew up in northern Alberta. The only difference I find, it's a lot windier in Winnipeg.
Same as you.
It is. We are very dedicated people to winter out here.
Whoa.
It's a dry cold.
Yep.
Good, Sherry.
Okay. And Sherry will lose her shooter.
That was here?
You see, Sherry is not even making her way down to the other end. Simple. They want to make sure that they have lots of time on their clock.
I was a little in
and was
out,
it not Chelsea Carey's team earlier this week, Kathy, that had some time trouble?
Twice. Twice they got shoulder checking and looking, and that may be a part of their plan today as well, to make sure that if things don't obviously look like it's going to go their way, that they have a simple end and save that time.
Hey. Top G, Eli. See you're better. Line's good. Right over there, yep.
Yeah, right team.
Yep, go.
She drew this path in the first end when she drew to split the house, and makes no mistake on her second attempt as well.
Okay, that's good. Just leave. Sweep, guys. Good.
Each team gets 40 minutes of thinking time.
No, I'll throw a little less, Joe. I'll throw a 10.
Of 90 seconds as well.
Okay.
And I've been asked many times, well, what happens when the time runs out? And I say, well, you lose. And it's as simple as that.
Clean,
see if
we
can roll it somewhere else. Yep, sweep it, roll it.
Good.
And so for the second consecutive end, Chelsea Carey will attempt the blank.
I was up and a little in over on you on the first one, but I still couldn't believe it ran that much.
Yep.
Final stone here in three for Chelsea Carey, trying to keep that hammer.
Clean. Good. Very nice.
Consider it done. Chelsea Carey successful with the blank. A low-scoring game here continues at the MTS Center.
Secret plan to lull everybody to sleep.
Welcome back to the MTS Center. On this tiebreaker Friday, we heard Chelsea Carey's comments just before commercial break. Our plan is just to lull everyone to sleep. Well, a lot on the line, obviously, and not a lot of offense thus far in a 1-0 game. Another blank in three. But now it looks like we will see a corner guard come up from the Chelsea Carey team.
Well, and Chelsea obviously just not comfortable with throwing guards if there was a stone in the forefoot. But as you'll see in about 2 seconds, there you go. That first stone thrown by Sherry Madaw's team in the 8 foot, not...
the crowd likes it.
The crowd goes, well, three. And you know what? As much as she's having fun with it, it really is important that you don't change your game plan, what you want to do, because you feel that the crowd might like something else.
Two. Okay. Line's good. Got some line.
They yelled two out, Kathy. Now, two is also in reference to zones in the ice.
Yeah, so that's about a halfway guard.
Line's really good. You don't have to go. Yes, two. Well, you don't have to go for line is what I'm saying. Whoa, easy, 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 easy. Good. Very nicely.
Yay. 12. Which turn looks better?
I maybe there's a little bit on this side.
Yeah, you should be able to get across the face with this turn anyway. It should go.
Okay. 12.
It's pretty much very. A couple feet more.
Well, you can see she gave her the options, but this side, there's a lot more latitude, if you will, because it's wide open. The other turn does have that corner guard there, and then you're not only dealing with trying to get through the port, but the right weight.
I have to go a little bit for line.
Line's fine.
Just line, there, just line.
Oh, then, no, then, no, then.
Just line.
Line
only.
Whoa, you don't. Close.
Top eight.
Close, yep. Yep. Hard.
Top 12, top eight.
Hard,
gotta get it by
hard,
that
hard,
guard
hard.
First, and they will rub.
Nice throw, Lynn.
Okay.
And it does jump. When watching the men's game this morning, John Epping's team was on that sheet, and I spent a lot of time watching it. And in that path, it almost
probably
hooks
right here is good,
when it starts to curl. Really goes hard.
Means she can't get the slack.
Okay.
Yeah, it's good over here.
Yeah, it'll just break hard at the end.
Line's good. Where?
Three.
Okay. No, 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 no. Still
three.
On the red. Whoa,
there.
Whoa, whoa.
Yeah,
whoa,
line's
no.
Really good.
Four. No. No.
There's the big hook.
It. Where's four,
in,
Kathy?
Yeah.
Now four will be in the 12 foot.
Bouncing.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa, whoa.
Oh, no. Okay, good weight call.
Good. And with that, Madaw lies two. Without hammer here in four.
You probably got to try to cross it. This one won't go, but lose the guard in the back one.
Okay.
Sure. 7/8 is pretty close.
So trying to open up that front a little bit, and in the process of doing it, drive it back so that it hits one of them.
No, it's 5 o'clock somewhere.
Yep, yep, yep.
Really
yep.
Great crowd here in Winnipeg this week. Even in this single game, lots of folks come out to watch. That's awesome.
Kristen Foster runs it back, opens it up a little bit, and removes a red stone.
Right here.
Okay, I need less weight.
Line was great.
There's a 10, Merck.
Just a 2.5, Merck.
Just reminding her a little bit. In front is where they're looking for.
Right, good. Two.
Right, line is really good.
Two.
Okay, line is good.
Easy. It's going to overcut, I think.
No, line looks pretty good.
This Madaw team has been on the ice since July, preparing for this event.
It's going to finish, I think.
Okay, right, coming down.
Yeah, a little bit. Whoa, whoa, you're good. You're good. Little.
And okay. The guard goes up.
A little left. Yeah.
Nice shooting.
It's quick
there.
Yeah,
so Pellinger.
Maybe.
I think so, yeah.
This turn?
Yeah.
Are we crossing the face?
Straight back. Okay.
And again, you'll hear that, and it may sound crazy for someone in the hack to ask which turn, but the hits on this ice are so very straight that essentially you could take the same ice and throw either the in or the out in this spot.
Whoa,
girl.
Oh, good throw. Okay, tough one.
Well, it is a tough one because not only do you miss the back one, but you leave that guard up there.
I do.
Tap
I think
it.
We're good as long as we're here.
Yeah, I don't think you tap yet.
Okay.
Do you agree?
Yeah.
Sure. Three. It's either that or we do a tap.
That's what we thought.
Pardon me?
We thought the tap.
I think it's a bit early.
Yeah, yeah. Okay.
Okay.
Same spot as Merck's.
Right?
Yeah, okay. Like a 20 for me?
Yeah, that's good.
Two considerations there. One of them is the tap. The tap
okay,
not only
three.
Puts two stones in the house,
then,
but it makes the shot stone better. It makes it closer to the forefoot. The challenge with the guard is if it's made, you continue to make Chelsea Carey run things in, but if she's able to do that, then all of a sudden she will have one buried behind a wall.
Hard pass the yellow.
Right up. That's good. That's good. That's good. Sorry, it just looked like it was running.
Just off nose, 7/8.
Okay. Okay, you got it.
Easy peel? Easy peel, yep.
Christy McDonald will attempt the run back, try to get her team out of some trouble.
Oh. Close.
No.
Yep. Whoa. Whoa. Whoa, whoa, whoa. Roll shooter away. Roll shooter away.
Nice throw.
And she'll remove the center guard.
Same spot.
I'm not sure, Joe.
Same thing then?
I think so, yeah.
Front end of Lee and Lee, a lot
right
of scrubbing
that's
so
good.
Far.
Right that's good. No, 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 no.
In this tiebreaker, a lot of brushing, and they'll drag it, put up another guard.
We could just,
yeah.
Good job.
Good sweep.
Can we draw around that?
We don't really have a great
doing
angle.
This one, and then if you just lose it, at least it opens up the side.
Christy's coming down.
Are you trying to run this one? Because
then
if we lose it, then we have the
well,
side.
Well, yeah, but if we miss it, she goes here, we're screwed. Yeah.
We could just go around the yellow.
I don't mind drawing there if we're going to do that. We just, because this double peel nuts here and goes here, right?
Yeah.
So that's no good. We could try it really thin, but it's scary thin to make it across this way.
Draw's pretty good too, Chels.
Yeah, I don't hate drawing.
Can I make that? I mean, is it going to hold out there?
Oh, you can make it for sure.
Okay.
I just don't, there's not really any way to lose two guards.
Yeah. I think we can make it, but the thing is, if we open it up, she's still going to plot another one in there, so.
Yeah, I just don't think you can lose two. I think that this one's jamming here, and the skinny is so skinny that I don't know that
she's
you can get the yellow to go this
ball.
Way.
That's why I think we should
yeah,
do
we can
it
play the draw, we can tap too, but I don't mind the draw if you like that. I think we draw for now.
Okay.
Playing the draw for now, because these guards up here cause the problems. If you try running any of these in, probably one goes on to here, and it may go on to there. But it's very unlikely. More often what would happen is you would promote that second redstone into the house, and that's certainly not what they're interested in. And so now changing tactics from defensive and peeling, given that there's five guards up front, to try to get shot stone in there.
Don't worry so much about line.
They're rejecting the tap up initially because they don't want to open it up for Sherry Madaw, trying to go around the outside. We know there's a huge break point on this sheet, and so they're going way out in the wings, hoping that there's enough ice to take.
And I guess, Kathy, if there is a silver lining to all that yellow out front, they are her stones that she could push back eventually if needed in a desperate situation.
For sure.
We have room.
Line good.
Can we switch?
Just for wing.
No,
just for wing.
Wait, good. Top four. Top four.
T. It's back. It's back. It's back. It's back.
By the guard, no problem.
Shoot. Sorry, Cage.
Sorry, Cage.
And it settles back eight. It will be shot stone.
Sorry, Cage.
Okay.
But that now allows Sherry to follow it down.
It does. Super's a little unsure, I think, just of the weight out there.
Because they got the yellow slams, so.
I like odd. We can be right to it as well.
You like odd, or we do need a bit more?
This one here, Sherry?
Or to it.
Yeah, well, we have to be careful with the run.
Okay.
Okay, right on the T-line.
Got it. T-line or back to it.
Okay.
95.
Okay.
Well, Sherry has seen this path just now with Christie's last stone. Now, but keep in mind that Christie was a little bit deep. They swept it and kept it out there.
Okay.
We'll start to bend really quickly.
Just keep it clean. Keep it clean.
Sherry Madaw with her first here in four. You hear the call. Hard line. Get it by that guard. They will. And now will it curl up nice for her? It will. And with that, Madaw shot stone.
Ah, did I? Thought I didn't quite get to you, so I was a little.
Oh, I thought you threw a crane.
I didn't get that, but.
It's a little more ice.
Same thing with the throwing, though.
Okay. Yeah, it's up to speed here, right?
Yeah.
Kathy, it'll be interesting as we get later in the game and the ends get more complex and the pressure gets more intense. In talking with Sherry, their last round robin game, she made a crucial mistake in that game in that eighth end. She really got caught up in the moment. She told me just before this game, she felt in that contest, she could make everything. And her fifth, Laura Eddy, did not because she was waving frantically going, what are we doing? Wishing they would have called a timeout at that moment. Sherry said they talked about it, they parked it, and they will learn from it.
Well, and that's important, and it is true that when you get on a roll, sometimes you start to just feel like you can make anything, but you still have to think about the risk and reward, the consequences of not making something. You don't want to have negative thoughts in your head, but you have to always think about outcome.
We're okay. Just full four, top full four. Line's really good. Yep. Oh. Great shot.
And a lovely shot by Chelsea.
Very nice. Good.
Yeah. Third or whatever. Yeah. I think up here. Right to it. And then she's got the tap, or she's got that tap, right?
Yeah. Okay. Okay. You got it.
Taking a little bit more ice. You guys didn't touch that a whole lot?
No, and we got 95.
Okay.
So it's real good.
Yeah,
here.
It's nice now. Only takes a couple rocks. Okay, odd ot. Odd ot. Okay, right on top of it. Good.
Yeah. Yeah, top eight, please, too.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Yeah.
And so for Sherry Madaw, going to come down to that stone. It's not about necessarily getting shot. It's about being right in front of it, closing down the scoring area for Chelsea. If she's able to be right on top of it, it would force Chelsea to look at one of those long runs or a tap. Just wants to change the shot for her.
Six.
Line's
really good.
Almost the same.
Six.
Easy, ladies. Felt like the same.
Felt like the same. Down. Here it comes.
No.
Bring it down. Just keep cleaning it.
We're there.
Stay close.
Don't want
Stay
it.
Stay close. Yep. Yep.
No,
yep.
Only for
right.
Weight.
Wait only.
Only for weight.
Yep. Right up. Come on. Yep. 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 Come on. Yep. Right up. Okay, good.
And they will drag it to touch the 8 foot. It is still shot stone belonging.
Okay, bye-bye.
To Chelsea Carey as now she tries to find a way to get two.
Good job. Okay. Three quarters will probably get you to full four.
Yeah.
You don't want to get too crazy with it.
Probably draw the button is half here, almost. So with back line, I'm thinking like there.
Okay.
And there's those yellow stones, Kathy, tons. We talked about it earlier.
Well, it's pretty high up, so let's remember it's a late break, so you might want to cut back.
Just talking about playing the raise on the stones, we've talked about how they're there, and so now it's a chance to utilize them.
75 over here. We haven't thrown a lot this way.
She's looking to throw about back 12, because don't forget she's got to move the stone about 12 feet. It's about 6 feet in front of the house, and then she needs 6 feet in the house to outcount that red stone at the back of the four.
And Kathy, you obviously go with the wide stone because the middle yellow rock brings in the possible jam and raising up the red rock as well.
Well, she's tight in the ice. I think she's now playing the middle one, Brian.
She is playing the middle one. The red one I'm talking about is just the top eight there. If you ever overcurl, you could tap them in for one. Final stone here in four.
Wait,
a
guys.
Tough tap Lots back shot. Try pick
there,
up two.
Yep.
Lots here.
Yeah. Whoa.
Lots.
Yes.
Yep.
Lots.
Hard.
Yes.
Hard.
We're on the brush the entire way down.
Hard.
They contact on that outside yellow stone. Now it needs to stop in time, and it won't. So a good effort, but just the single. And we're all tied up here at one at the MTS Center in Winnipeg. Welcome back to Winnipeg, Manitoba. Round robin complete here at the Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings. And last night, this crowd had something to cheer about. A fantastic shot, Kathy, arguably the best one we've seen all week considering the circumstances.
Well, it was indeed for Brad Jacobs, line one, trying to find a way to score two. And this isn't one of those high, high heaters that he can often throw. It's a controlled hit. Wait, look at that great brushing to keep it straight.
Final stone for Brad Jacobs in 10, taking on Kevin Martin. Look at the tap back, and look at the two. And with that, a bye to the final. You think he's fired up? Unbelievable. I talked to Ryan Fry last night, and he called that the best shot considering the circumstances he's seen Brad Jacobs make. What a shot. What a championship. We will have Brad Jacobs in the final, the semifinal, Saturday, 2:30 Eastern time. Former teammates of Kevin Martin and John Morris will go head to head. It's been a fantastic week. It'll be a great weekend. Meantime, on this Friday afternoon, it's our tiebreaker. Winner moves on to the semifinal tonight to take on Rachel Holman. We're all tied up at one here after four ends of play. And finally, Kathy, in that final end, we did see some rocks in action.
Well, I think both teams now feeling confident with draw weight. Some very nice draws made last end. And so we're in this right away.
Carey scores the single in four, so Sherry Madaw has the hammer back here in five, all locked up at one.
And you can see there's redstone at the back of the house. Lee Armstrong coming very deep, allows Chelsea Carey to ignore it and try to make a better one.
Go.
Oh, dear.
Another going was more for finish than for weight.
Roll here. Got it.
This is the curly side, okay?
Think hack will be good.
You got it.
Yeah. Want to roll here.
Hack!
Easy. Whoa. Whoa. Nothing yet.
Hack.
Getting close.
No.
Whoa. Yes! Hard! Hard! You're going, Joe!
Lee Armstrong makes the hit.
Sorry, Lee, I didn't anticipate.
They will avoid the jam, and Sherry does lie too.
And the anticipation that she's talking about is that she hasn't seen that many stones come down here with that kind of weight in this game. Did not anticipate the break.
Yeah. Easy 10.
Really wanted to roll farther away from that guard.
The roll was more important than the double there, Kathy?
Right here, Lee.
Oh, yeah, they were never really looking at the double. They've got that center guard. We're really trying to play to roll underneath.
Yeah, the big roll is good. Just a 10.
A 10?
Yeah.
Lots of talking.
You got it. It's just kind of popped it at the end.
Okay.
Back to it.
Back one?
Yeah. Yeah, back eight.
Got 10
was the weight okay?
Yeah.
Four,
minus five?
Not good.
Okay.
Back eight.
Line's good.
Okay, it's to it.
Line's fine.
I'm fine. Plus curl a bit. Wait only.
Let it work a bit if you can.
Just cleaning.
Need some move.
There.
I'm fine.
Needs to move.
I'm fine. It's all you. Always. Always.
Back to it.
Line's really good. Right to it.
Back to it.
Right to it. Line's perfect. Yep. Line's perfect. Right to it.
Go.
Okay,
go,
right
go, 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 go.
That one settles back nice four.
That's a line forever.
Yeah.
Kathy, one of the storylines coming in was...
Okay, quarter.
Sherry Madaw, her draw weight, how strong she has been.
Same
do you also
as,
feel part
Arby's.
Of that, though, is...
Well, I can... Are you talking about over-curling?
No, yeah. You want to hit this side.
I don't know if I like that.
Well, I don't like that. We're back button, Enley. There's space. You're only throwing hack.
Arm strong?
Yeah. Well, you can try and come under with hack, then. Mm-hmm. Hack.
Just to finish my thought there, Kathy, Sherry's obviously her draw weight's been fantastic as we just listen into the players.
Get a word of it.
Her ability, though, to read the ice and knowing when it's going to break, because a lot of the skips, men's and women's sides, have really had trouble at times with the tricky ice.
Well, you know, it's interesting because we call it tricky, but a lot of times the skips, like Kevin Martin will tell you, it's not tricky. It's just that you have to throw the weight that you've been asked. And Lee wasn't comfortable rolling away.
Big scrub here to get by the guard, and they won't.
And that was the risk of trying to play it under. Sherry just wanted to make sure that they rolled across. And I think from the hack to Lee, it looked like those stones were closer to each other than they were and thought that was too tough.
Hit the back one or you want to go in front of it somewhere?
What do you like?
Well, I wanted to freeze here, but now that guard's in the way.
Yeah, I don't think I can. Yeah. I don't think that'll go there.
You can tap it, but...
You want to try into it? Bump it back a little? Bump it a little closer?
You play like bumped at it or?
Well, or else we just try this.
Might as well. Like,
I don't love it though with the corner guard.
I mean, it's pretty straight up. What, like 3 feet?
Yeah, well, sure it's, I mean, but it's just high side of nose.
As long as I stick one.
Normal?
Just stick one for sure.
Yeah, just easy normal. 9-5.
Chelsea's concerned about that stone at the back of the house that belongs to Sherry Madaw. She's got two options. One of them is that she can try to protect her stone or throw another one in there. But her concern is that if they allow a double, then all of a sudden two comes into play. And so they're running their own stone back, which is very defensive. You certainly don't want to pick out your own and allow the free draw for two.
Right over.
Nicely done. Obviously, you always want to make the shot that you call, but would you ever consider, obviously, without hammer, throw a guard there?
9.5.
Yeah, you could, and I think that if that stone were 1.5 feet higher, they probably would have done that, but because it was behind the tee line, they're guarding a stone that Sherry Madaw would go around and bury, and then they would be chasing, and that's why they didn't.
I think we maybe just nose it.
Yeah.
I don't really like this.
I'd rather nose, but
just
got to err on the inside.
I mean, if we make this, fine, but I think this is better.
Yeah.
Normal.
And the concern with rolling behind the corner is that it's going to be behind the tee line, and then you're giving something for Sherry Madaw to draw to, and you really don't want to be playing out into the wings when you are in a situation where you can lie to.
Side
and the roll,
that's not bad either.
Okay,
9.5.
You got this.
Two good options for Joanne. They're playing the intern side so that if it does happen to hang out a little bit, they can get the roll behind the guard. But they're also
nine
playing
half.
It that side
oh,
because the double
oh,
is certainly
yeah.
there as well.
Oh, yes! Hard!
Joanne
yes!
Rizzo.
Hard!
Hit one, right get them both. Nice double.
Yeah, don't be too aggressive with it, though, because if we roll too far.
A little soft.
That good plan B by Sherry. There was no question they were playing the double, but when it was curling too much, she started to play the double the other way. Nicely called.
I'd love to roll a rock, but we can't be aggressive because if we roll too far, she just goes around it.
Okay.
If you can, if you can roll it right to the edge of the four.
Okay.
Nine, yeah, just a little off. 9-7 to 10.
Chelsea Carey, her first here in five.
Okay, sorry.
Pretty good. We'll make it go away.
That's five?
Sure.
Couple veterans of the game, of course, Randy Ferbey, all that success with Dave Nettowin, arguably the best team on the planet for around a decade, and Rob Meakin, obviously disappointment for him this week, Kathy.
Well, it would have been for sure. For Rob, worked so hard with Jeff Stoughton's team, of course, a member of Kerry Burtnick's World Championship team, and his daughter, Brianne. He's also here to support her in the fifth role as Chelsea Carey's player.
And Brianne has a big week coming up, does she not?
Well, she's scheduled to leave tomorrow. She's already talked to the coach about perhaps leaving on Sunday, depending on how the team does. She will be traveling to Italy to participate in the World University Games. It's a fifth for Laura Crocker's team from Alberta.
Sherry Madaw makes the hit. How far can she roll? Get behind cover. And she will find a little bit of room behind that corner guard.
Lindsay's corner guard took forever to get off the line.
We got to be back eight.
Well, and we have to be shot. We can't over curl it.
We got
to
be shot and we
got
to be two.
I just got it going on you a bit. I don't think this way is going to curl quite as hard.
Not until it gets to the line anyway?
Yeah. Your corner guards are taking forever to get over there coming this way, so.
Four of those still, same as you've been throwing.
Okay.
Right to it?
Right to it, yeah.
Right, same as you've been throwing.
A little short as obviously we can't bounce, but.
No.
Lots of good discussion all the time. I've noticed Chelsea in the hack. No question that her sweepers know exactly where she wants to be, what's not good. Really good information sharing.
Final stone for Chelsea Carey here in five. This crucial tiebreaker. Winner moves on to the semifinal tonight against Rachel Holman.
Don't touch it.
Wait, it's good. T.
Don't touch it.
T.
Let it work.
No, never.
Needs a big finish. Want to lock it on that red stone. And a very nice shot.
Wow. That's really straight. I threw that soft and it still didn't work.
She was good.
And it looks like Chelsea Carey did the job as the force is on, as Sherry will draw for her one.
Maybe a little bit more ice then. I'll just go T-line.
Yes.
Did you get it, Joe?
I did. 14-5.
Okay.
Yeah, they gave more ice. They're less. We're just doing straight dry.
Some great crowds in here at
straight dry.
One game in play. Yeah. Lots of support for the local team as well as people that just love curling and want to see a great game.
Maybe an odd-ought there.
I like odd-ought.
Yeah, I was going to say that slid pretty.
Not only great crowds, Kathy, very knowledgeable crowds, too. Winnipeg is such a hotbed for curling.
Okay. Well, a good result for Chelsea Carey for sure. Yeah. That stone took a long time to curl over, and that showed Sherry Madaw that there's really not a shot to get to the inside and try to tap it back or create any deuce opportunities. So well done to the Chelsea Carey team for the force. For Sherry Madaw, another big draw.
Line's good.
Line's good, guys.
Line's good.
Just got to bite the four.
Final stone on the way here in five for Sherry Madaw.
Line's good.
Line's good.
Easy. It looks like it's skating.
No one's been able to crack a deuce yet in this contest.
Easy, please.
Madaw, that single in
not
one.
No backing.
Carey answered in four.
No backing. No backing.
And this draw will stop in time for the single. Sherry Madoff with a 2-1 advantage after five here in Winnipeg.
The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by World Financial Group, creating a better tomorrow for families today. WFG. The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by Cashmere Bathroom Tissue. Nothing feels like cashmere. By M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best. And by Capital One, what's in your wallet?
Well, it's been a very tight game so far. We expected that it would be a bit tentative. It is really important to get through, and following that game plan is a big, big part of it. And Brian is with Chelsea.
Chelsea, quite a few blanks in this game thus far. We caught you saying and joking around, we're going to maybe bore them to sleep in this game. Did you expect it to be so low scoring so early?
Not really. I mean, in the first end, we play it always that way. And then in the second end, we actually threw a corner guard, but then we rolled out and she peeled it. And then in the third end, when she went, we don't mind blanking an odd end, so we had decided that that's what we were going to do if she went in. So, yeah, I felt a little bad for the crowd, but it was kind of our game plan to blank the third end. And then the fourth end, they couldn't be mad at us anymore because we put a whole bunch of rocks in there.
You talk about a game plan. How important is it to be patient in a game like this and pick your spots?
You really have to be, especially in 10 ends. It's such a long game. I mean, everybody's used to 8 because we play more spiels with 8 ends than we do with 10. So it really makes a big difference. You don't mind burning an end or two because you're used to playing 8 ends. So yeah, you gotta be patient and wait. If you try to force it on ice like this, it's really conducive to shot making. So you try to force it too much, they make a couple good shots, you get yourself in some trouble. So we're okay to be a little patient with it.
Finally, how much fun playing at home this week?
Amazing, unreal. I can't say enough about the crowd and the support and you know, the people coming up to me and asking me for pictures and autographs. And it's like, I'm new to this. I don't know how to deal with that. So it's been more than I could have ever expected.
Thanks for your time.
My pleasure. Thank you.
Well, a pretty simple game can lead to some pretty high numbers. We'll take a look at these numbers after five, and it's brought to you by Tim Hortons, Canada's favorite coffee. Well, you see the numbers. They are very high, both for draws and hits. And when you look at the skips and the thirds, they're 88, 85, 90. It's almost like we're waiting for a big break. Somebody's going to have to make a big shot, and that could be the one shot that determines the outcome. No longer with Last Rock, Sherry Madaw will have to find a way to force Chelsea Carey to make that big shot. We'll be back with the final five right after this.
Only one sheet underway and in action this afternoon. And Kathy, it's obviously a very big game. It's a tiebreaker. Winner moves on to the semifinal tonight to take on Rachel Holman. The loser, their Olympic hopes are over. And it's been a very close game as we chatted with Chelsea in the fifth end break. No one scored a deuce as of yet. It was the single by Madaw in five. So Sherry Madaw has the 2-1 lead with action underway here in six. And Kathy, how do you see the final five ends here playing out?
Well, I found it really interesting, a couple of things that Chelsea did say, which I thought one was just so informed. And that is the reality that we've talked a number of times this week about how aggressive we found some of the men's teams in particular going after each other. And I think that has a lot to do with the Bonspiel season that is all eight ends. People are used to, you know, being in a situation if after six you're down, you have to go really, really hard. These are 10-end games. These are the only times that these teams will play 10 ends all year. In this trials, the road to provincial championships and at Canadian championships, and it's a very different mindset. You can afford to be patient. You can afford to pick your spots. And Chelsea clearly, you know, was noticing that and recognizing that, and I think that's important.
Lindsay Titheridge puts up the tight corner guard, and as you see, it was Lee Armstrong with her first one, finding the 8-foot with her second one here on the wing.
I guess I didn't really answer your question about playing out. I think that both skips have started to try to force each other to either give up the point or to just take one. And it's been the last rock throwers on both teams that have made really good shots when they've needed to take that single point or to force the single point.
I know these teams have played each other a lot, Kathy, but they did meet in the final game of the round robin. Do you learn or take anything from that when you go right back and play them again right away?
For sure you do.
Or go here.
For sure you do, especially that was only yesterday. And, you know, you play each other on different Bonspiel weekends. Different things are happening. Somebody's having a good weekend, a bad weekend. But to have played and to have seen what their tendencies are, what they seem to like, what they do in a situation, all of that information is helpful. Plus, Dan Carey would be down there, as would the coach for Sherry Madaw's team, Bob Turcotte, looking at tendencies of the team, not only when they play each other, but when they play other people. Those things are all, it's all data that you can use for your own game.
What I found really interesting, too, in the men's game, John Morris, Kevin Martin, and the strategy. John Morris playing with Kevin for so many years, he maybe would call shots that not a lot of skips would, because he knows what Kevin is going to do.
For sure. We even heard him say at one point this morning, knowing Kevin, ... And he made the choice based on that.
If you just miss it, you'll go here.
Okay.
Just firmer.
Yeah.
Really
this
will run.
Here, right?
Yeah. That good?
Looking to run that guard straight back and pick it out. If not, they're going to roll towards the center and build up those center guards in the hopes of a steal.
Whoa.
And also open up the back stone.
Whoa. Whoa, 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 whoa.
No roll.
No, roll. No roll. Okay.
Okay, that's fine.
That's good.
She will not stick around. Chelsea taking a good look to see who shot. It sort of looks like red. I agree with you.
Split. Or hit and roll. Okay, yep.
Yeah. Yeah, let's roll it here.
Dumb comment.
Normal.
Have to make sure we stick the shooter.
All right.
Just normal?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
It's normal, right?
Normal, yep.
Big.
9-5.
Right off. Kristen Foster.
It's not only removal of the stone, they want it to stick around for a corner.
9-1.
That was 9-1. It'll finish here, okay?
And so mission accomplished for Sherry Madaw without last rock here in 6. Got that corner guard off, forced play to the middle, and now that stone is open and can hit to lie too.
Hard! Right there, hard, hard! Right there, good.
Lee Merklinger hits and sticks. Glasses on for the throwing, glasses off for the sweeping.
Yeah, I used to do the same thing. The depth perception thing.
Wait, close.
It really slides. Just kind of
line's close.
Take a look.
Line's good.
Yeah, line a little
hold
bit.
Hold it for line a little bit.
Yep.
I think it's
yeah.
There.
Whoa,
hey, well then. Whoa, line's line fine. Line's fine.
Trying to freeze on the corner right of the shot
freeze
stone.
It. Right to it. Yep.
Freeze it.
Hard line, yep.
Hard line, guys.
Hard. Go, 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 go,
keep
go, 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 go.
Okay.
Okay.
Do
you know
what? What is happening?
Kristen. Chris.
We're one for sure. 1-2.
Oh, what do you like for 1-2?
Like guarding that?
What do you guys think?
On the top. We're 1-2.
Yeah, I was thinking the tap. I'm not really sure. Want to call time?
You like the tap on the top one?
I don't think we need to if we tap it in the open. I'm not sure why we would.
I was thinking they tap, and we go around.
Want to call it time?
Yeah.
I'm not really
time.
Sure.
So they'll use their first of two timeouts that they are allowed and
the
call
out
Bob Turcotte for his
we
view.
Set up a double, then a 2-3.
What are you thinking?
Oh, I was thinking a center here. Line guard.
Yeah, I wasn't
are we lying
sure.
too?
Yeah.
You can come here. Is that crazy?
Yeah. We come here. Is that crazy?
Yep.
Okay. I think you either pick it or you put up a center line guard.
Well, well we saw that spot before. It runs pretty straight there.
Well,
you
can
pick
it. Nice but then to keep they're that in the way for
again.
Them.
Yeah. Yeah.
I don't mind the guard then because I don't like the pick.
Yeah.
You don't like the pick?
No. They're going to freeze to it again and make it better.
Right.
And
so
right.
when we guard it, what's she going to do?
I don't know.
She's probably going to run that into it.
Yeah, that's fine. Or then we have a double and
she's
we're
probably going to run the guard.
Spill back here,
run the
right?
guard into that stuff.
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe get lucky.
Yeah.
Okay, well, we know the spot for the guard.
Okay. Just 2.5.
What's better, tighter?
2.5.
I played this way before with the guard. Does it matter which way I turn I come?
No. Do you like that? This side straighter.
Okay, it doesn't matter.
We know
matter.
This.
What's better? If we have to.
I like a 2.5.
So they're playing the guard. One of the things they talked about
okay,
was either that.
But then she runs it and she controls the front.
Or that you come in and you play the top. So your stone is here and you've got one there. The other thing that they talked about was playing the hit on this stone just to pick that stone out. I definitely don't like that. I think you can either tap if you want or you throw a guard. The risk right now is they're already lying two. You chip out the Chelsea Carey stone and she comes back down and freezes better. And now you're chasing. You're lying two already, stay aggressive. You've got a great chance to steal here or again, force the one.
You know what I love about that, Kathy, regardless of the shot choice, is that they called the timeout, took the time, discussed it amongst the entire team. In SportsCenter, we always do a flashback or a TSN turning point, and I remember their last game in that eighth end where they didn't take the time. Nice to see them take the time there.
Try this.
Yeah, I don't mind trying that now.
Your shooter might go, or the raised rock might go here, but I think we gotta try it anyway. Just roll off a hair.
You don't want to hit it on this side?
No, it's okay. It's
well, then you have to hit it on the nose.
No, I don't. Want a little.
It's gonna
okay,
go
okay. Yeah, true. Okay.
I don't really like leaving your shooter there.
Yeah. All right.
It should go over top.
Okay, so where do you want to hit it?
Just off nose on this side.
You can see how straight it is with big weight. Chelsea's put the broom right in the middle of the rock, and that's where pretty much she would like Christy to hit it.
Keep in mind, Chelsea Carey does have hammer. Down by one here in six.
Quick! Really hard!
Roll shooter!
Roll shooter!
Go, go, go!
Hard!
They were trying to hit it on the other side entirely, Kathy, weren't
they? Were. Now?
I like it.
Yeah.
Or you just come around.
Uh-uh. Come around. She's got
Ashley, you know what? Just come around, then we'll be 1, 2, 3. Okay?
Yeah. She's got this double, though, right?
Okay, it's nice here. We saw this.
It's rather messing with what's there.
Where do you want it? Like, full eight?
We got to be buried.
So that she doesn't have the double.
She's probably going to have the double all day anyhow. But we just don't want to hang out and leave that. I think you're good here and buried. She's always going to have that.
Okay. She's always going to have that, but she's also going to be playing off your stone. And you have to leave them something, so a great opportunity here for Team Madaw on the sixth end to get another stone in, buried.
Kathy, I always know the goal is to try and force to one when you don't have the hammer. But at what point in an end like this do you decide to maybe put the pedal down and really go hard for a steal?
Oh, this is all about stealing
right
for
now.
Sure, you bet.
Come off the yellow.
Too late. Okay. Yeah. Yeah.
Option B, a little tick on the yellow.
Good call, Joe.
Hey, good judge.
Do they still lie three? I think so.
Yes.
All right. I didn't think I was that heavy. What'd you get?
And so this is now the double.
Yep.
Christy McDonald trying the outturn double here in six.
Yes!
Bang the red, drive it back. And how far can they move it? Not out of the rings, but it looks a little bit better.
It sure does. All of a sudden, you're now 2 and 3. If it hangs out just that little bit,
I thought so too.
Little bit more, she would have got the double and rolled out completely. But she did what she needed to do, which was get that stone off the forefoot, opened up the path.
Getting a little scary because she runs that,
and the yellow are starting to build.
Get second. We can get shot with.
Pardon me?
We can get shot if we roll, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. Like a 10. This will come up a bit.
10.
Right?
Yeah.
Okay. Not a long way to roll. Like this?
Yeah.
Okay. 10.
You got this.
Those yellow stones building up in the house, even though Sherry is shot stone.
Okay.
Wants to make sure that they don't give up a pile in this end, and so we'll remove the third shot stone. And the biggest thing in not only removing the stone, but is the big finish that she's looking for with the roll.
Okay, 10, like you can.
Yeah. Does that look like a lot, or is that good for 10?
I like it. It could be okay.
10.
Lots of Scotty's experience. That all helps at this level.
Whoa, whoa, whoa,
whoa, whoa.
Lean it.
Close. Whoa, whoa.
Whoa.
Whoa. Not enough.
Whoa.
Not enough of it.
No, it's running.
They need a piece. Don't want to flash to get enough to remove it.
She threw it really well.
Yeah, I was worried about that.
Real good weight.
I was worried. We had one over there in the game over on D that ran.
Rolls out. I think if we make the roll, it's good.
I was thinking
right?
That looked like a lot of ice.
I guess I could just draw there too.
Yeah, I actually like even just
yeah
a little
full,
higher,
full bite forefoot.
Yeah, just so that she can't.
So that it sets up this.
Yeah.
Although then she has this.
No, but if you're a little higher, she doesn't have it.
Yeah, we got to be
you're
shot
here,
though, right?
She has it.
Yeah. What do you guys like?
We probably can't play this without.
But it
not
won't.
Being
this
shot,
one
right?
Won't stick. That'll out count it.
Yeah.
We can play it, but.
Yeah.
What if you drew like right to here?
Yeah. Then she just follows it, but maybe I have something.
Whatever you like.
Yeah. Like she can't really. Then she can't play that as too.
No, but she just follows
me
down.
Just follows
right?
You
she
down.
Just goes here.
So.
She's got to be tall, like just fully.
I don't mind this.
Okay. Make her
just try
double.
To nut it there and get as much roll as we can.
Okay.
Even if it's wide open, it's not terrible because you won't have a double if it gets edge to edge,
or
right?
Or if you just nick it and you roll behind the guard, that's pretty good too.
Right, either way. But if we roll just edge to edge and nut it here,
yeah.
It's pretty good because you won't have a double, right?
Yeah.
I like it.
Okay. What kind of weight?
I like a little bit of weight to try to nut it there, but just not like 9.5, like not weight, but.
Okay.
Normal, solid, normal, 9, 9.5.
Does that look a little narrow
a little
to you?
Less.
Less?
Just like solid normal so you can hit
solid
more of
normal.
It?
Solid normal, yeah.
Okay. And you want it to be as buried as possible? Or?
I'd like to, well, even edge to edge is a good roll.
Okay. Initially, they didn't like this call because they felt with the shot that they're going to make, this stone right here is going to be out-counting it. But when they've
like
gone
nine,
through
nine,
the discussion,
right. Nine,
they're going to get rid of shot stone, which belongs to Sherry Madaw, and they're going to leave two stones there. And if she doesn't make the double, then they have the opportunity. She also has some options that if it starts to curl in, she may get some roll in towards the center with her shooter.
Close. Close.
No.
Close.
Right off.
Really close.
Anything?
Yep.
Roll the back one.
Yep.
Yep.
Okay.
And it is now Chelsea Carey lying two.
Is that there?
It is.
Okay,
and so did not quite get the finish that she was hoping for, and so her shoot as she walked down was referring to the fact that it's a relatively simple double, but she still has to make it.
Okay, so nose hit.
Both these teams coming in with 4 and 3 records.
Nine.
Close.
The only tiebreaker needed on both the men and women's side.
Yes.
Sherry Mada, her final stone here in six without, needs the double. She'll get them both. Very nice shot.
Well, it's a good shot. We talk all about her draw weight, but when she has to make the big hit, she can certainly throw the weight. Former Saskatchewan skip when she was playing out of Saskatchewan. No question about her hitting ability. She's just more known for her draws this week. A lovely double.
No problem.
And again, the force.
I'm going, is Joe going to see a pop or is she going to see a clean?
No. I knew you were going to throw one.
Yeah.
So another pressure shot here for Chelsea Carey. Facing two red stones. The good news with her final stone just needs full 8 foot.
19. Mm-hmm. Off if it's heavy.
It's fine.
Starting to move.
It's fine.
Curling out.
Good tee line. Good.
So the trend continues. It's a story of single points thus far in this tiebreaker on Friday. One on the board. For Carey, it's 2-2 after six. Kathy, we talked a lot about Sherry Mada and her great draw weight this week. Well, the skipper came through with a clutch double as well.
Well, she did. There were situations this end where it looked like they may be forcing against three, but then a good shot by Chelsea Carey means that she has to make the double, and she does. Puts the pressure back on Chelsea Carey yet again.
The key shot is brought to you by Scotty's Tissue, the perfect touch of design and softness. You get the feeling, Kathy, as we roll on here in this crucial tiebreaker. Now tied up at two. First deuce just may win it.
I don't disagree with you or the first really great shot or first half shot that somebody takes advantage of as this game gets further into it. Both skips doing a great job. Both teams doing a great job at going back and forth, keeping pressure on their opponent.
So in the seventh end, it is all tied up. Sherry Mada has the hammer back.
Gotta go. Hard. Hard. Line's really good.
Top 12.
Quick.
Of course, the winner will move on to that semifinal tonight against Rachel Holman.
Hard. Gotta go.
Sherry Mada knows that young team very well. She was their fifth back at the Scotties in 2011 in PEI.
It's very normal here.
Yeah.
Just a corner freeze.
I got on that, so it's quick. They swept it the whole way, though.
Looking to corner on that stone just thrown by Lindsay.
This side seems to run, guys. This side is running a bit better.
Line only.
Yeah, I see that.
We're gonna bump.
Yeah, we're behind. We're past it.
Mine's good. Yeah, well, we're on it already.
Good to rearrange them.
Sure, if you want. Yep. Hard. Great shot, Lee.
Good communication down the ice, and it's so much easier with one sheet in play. We will see that for the rest of the weekend now. As that plays out, you're not trying to outshoot your opponent. They actually had a great conversation. Here's where the weight is, and Sherry was able to hear it earlier in the week, even this morning with four sheets on. Hear lots of hoarse voices from trying to outshout what's going on in the next sheet.
Line should be close.
Pretty close. Close.
Top eight. Room.
Has to move.
Lots of room.
Has to move. Line's close. Breaker is there.
I'm good.
Top 12, top eight.
Let it work if you can.
Top 12, good.
No, it's all there.
Line's really good.
Line.
Yep.
Line's good. Line's good. Right to it. Right to it. Whoa. Let it work. Great shot.
Beauty.
Kathy, I know when you played and now you do some coaching as well.
Try again for a corner.
You see a lot of rocks in play now. How much in practice? We know that you work out and you're going to the gym. You're working on your sweeping. How much do teams actually practice angles?
Am I just peeling that?
Yep.
Okay, with a 10?
Just going to let them finish for a sec. A good teams should be practicing it a lot. That is a huge part of it, is understanding the way that where you hit stones will react, how they will react, what the drag looks like. It's hard in a game situation to try to figure that out for the first time. So that should be a part of a practice so that you have a confidence with where you need to hit stones and what the results or the expected results should be.
It's either that or we play this.
Can we kill them both?
Tight, but maybe.
Are we touching
this back one?
If you hit it,
even if it doesn't clip it, though, it's not terrible if you roll to here and just leave a bunch of yellows.
It's probably clipping ours, eh?
What?
No, it's not clipping ours.
No?
It might just go by.
It won't touch ours unless we hit it on this side. If we hit it here,
whatever
it won't
like,
touch
Charles.
Ours.
I'm good with whatever you like.
I don't mind this.
Okay.
Normal?
Solid normal to if you, in case you clip this one.
Question was whether you hit that yellow stone on the nose or any part of the nose. If both reds go, the back one goes for sure. But with the angles, you may very well touch the second yellow one, and that would stop it from making contact with the second red one.
No.
Kristen Foster. A big weight throw here.
Hard.
Moves the one red out. Second red settles back 12, and for now it is Chelsea Carey lying two without here in seven.
Try and go here.
Sure.
Yeah, no, this is okay too.
Dan.
This is my eight.
Pardon me? Eight? Okay.
That weight was good?
I think so.
It was, yeah.
Lee Merklinger, part of her routine, the big breath of air.
Clean.
As she zones in, delivers her stone.
Clean it. Got the nose. Whoa. What you got, Army?
Lee, whatever you got.
That's good. Well done. Good. Prepare.
No, I don't think so.
Chelsea trying to line up weather contact with
the this one too.
Yellow, both reds go.
Okay.
You hit it a hair high and stick both yellows, that's not bad either.
Okay. Yeah.
Nose
eight
and is half. The call?
No. Eight and a half. No, we gotta be a little long here outside. I'm not gonna get cute here. Let's make sure we get it. Can't roll.
Okay, normal up. Eight and a half.
Do you care about the shooter here, Kathy? You need to stick around?
Yeah, you'd really like to stick around for sure, Brian.
Whoa. Yep. Whoa, to stick shooter.
Whoa
to stick shooter. Whoa.
Bang the reds, catch nice the second shot. One. Nice. You bet she can. Very nice shot.
Good shot. They were hoping to stick the shooter just again to keep that force on for Sherry Madab. It makes the lovely double and just rolls out.
Okay, just rolled out.
Pair up, maybe.
Easy. No, right off.
Easy. Roll this way.
Here comes, yep.
Yep. Hard.
Right up.
Right up. What you got,
right
Abby?
Up.
Right up.
Go.
Kathy, I just made the observation watching this Chelsea Carey team. You know, a lot of great players from Winnipeg throw the tuck.
Yes.
And you look at the men's side, there's certainly a lot of them. And in watching Jennifer Jones's team and Chelsea Carey's team, I don't really notice a lot of the tuck. Am I wrong?
Yes.
Okay, thank you. Great discussion. Carry on.
I don't know if you could see Christy's heel on that. They are not as obvious a tuck. They're certainly not flat foot, but their back heel often will come up a little bit. But you're absolutely right in that they're not the full tuck as you see with Jeff and with Mike. But there are a lot of youngsters, both boys and girls, that are definitely doing the tuck still.
Spot, but got to it, I guess.
Especially look at the junior ranks in Manitoba. It still is very, very popular. And at one point it was not taught and it was not corrected because everything was going to flat foot. And now I know that at the club that I was working at for years, it wasn't about changing somebody's delivery. It was about helping them with it. If you throw tuck, then let's help you throw it well.
I remember too, Reed Carruthers, a very interesting story. A guy who threw tuck for many years, had some really serious knee issues, had to redevelop himself and his delivery.
And with his surgery, he just physically he could not go back into a tuck, and so had to learn to throw flat foot.
Stay close to this. I think we should be inside the spot where it's going to curl, but it might.
Now that great hit and then double by Christy McDonald has led to the situation now where Sherry Madaw is playing for the blank to keep last rock and that all-important eighth end.
Chelsea Carey with her first here in seven in a 2-2 tie in this crucial tie-breaking game, with the winner moving on to the semifinals tonight on TSN.
Tan,
you want to just stay there?
Or roll a bit this
roll?
Way. Sure, yeah. The last, Joe.
Chelsea staying down, okay, Sherry staying down. Not wasting a lot of time, which is not to suggest that these shots are not important. They absolutely are, but there's not a lot of thinking time or discussion when there's one rock in play. Chelsea would like to roll a little bit somewhere so she does not give Sherry Madaw the same shot, and ideally to the center side if she could, but she'll beak it.
That was a nine.
Almost rolled
it in this
one.
Want this?
You see the scoreboard there in the distance, all tied up at two. This would be the third blank of this game, as Sherry Madaw hopes to keep hammer final stone here in seven, playing the blank once again.
Clean it.
And hearing that clean it is always nice on the skip's heart to know that you got a piece, and she removes it as this very close game continues here at the MTS Center. We're back after this. There's a look at Glenn Howard, his wife Judy, and of course Wendy Howard, Russ's wife, and Glenn, one of the best in the business for many years. Obviously a very disappointing showing at 2-5 this week, as he's now a spectator, but we've really enjoyed watching him over the years. Came so close in Edmonton, you bet. Made the final in 2009. It was just not to be for his team. As we bring you back to our feature game, a tiebreaker between Sherry Madaw and Chelsea Carey. The singles continue to go on the board. We're all tied up at two here.
Oh, darn. Okay.
And it's the same song and dance for us, Kathy, every end, but really, you're just waiting for that breakout shot. Someone to score a deuce will obviously be the difference as we're running out of ends.
Well, and that stone placed right on the Tim Hortons center, and Sherry Madaw just not comfortable with that being there, and that's why she played the hit, and of course now Chelsea will play the hit, because she does not have last rock.
Clean. Oh, right off.
No, get off it.
Right off. A little big, maybe.
Right off. 9-6.
Just a little spinny.
Just a little spinny, yeah.
Just set that a little, eh?
Just a touch, spinny. Yeah. No. Yeah. Some of us more than others. I won't name names.
You can tell me later.
Well, and a huge part of this game sometimes is patience.
Halfway.
And, you know, you have to pick and choose your spots. And for someone like Chelsea, who does not have last rock, you can start to feel anxious about wanting to force things. For Sherry, she looks at the score. You don't want to wait till 10. But that stone was just in a place that she wasn't comfortable with. And with that rollout, is very comfortable throwing a corner guard.
And that, Kathy, was my question to Chelsea in the fifth end break. How important patience is in a contest like this. and not forcing it when you don't have to, and making sure you're comfortable with your strategy in the situation.
Well, I think for Chelsea Carey, what she's showing us is that she's comfortable to wait and to try to steal. Either coming home or nine, but she may not have that opportunity. Or she may need to steal more than one or two, and so with that corner guard, Sherry Madaw's team will try to get in there.
The flash from Kristen Foster opens the door now for Sherry. We'll use that corner guard.
Yeah, it should be.
You want the eight?
Yes, please.
Okay.
Kathy, when you were playing on the big stage and in these big events, was it hard as a player to be in these games? Not a lot of rocks in play, close game, or did you prefer the ones where there was a ton of rocks in play and a lot of strategy? Was there any difference as a player out there?
No, you're enjoying every second of the moment, and you know, it was all about making your shots and controlling what you could, and trying to help as a brusher to make the shots for the rest of the teammates that you're with. It's really about the game. You don't need a complicated game to feel like you've come through something really important.
Well, we're on it. Well, yeah.
And after Foster with the flash, it's Merklinger will rub her own guard.
Yeah, she just tipped it.
Well, and the worst part about that and not coming in is that she rolled to a center guard. And so for Chelsea Carey now, they're trading turns at having a little bit of a break.
98 on yours, and it's kind of there.
Is this the same as Lindsay had?
No, she had more, but she didn't cross center.
I was wondering.
Looks like a lot of a curl here, Kathy, with the out turn.
It definitely curls more with the in turn.
You gotta go a bit.
But there is movement with the out turn for sure. It's on the hit weights or the up weights that they tend to run a little bit.
Lots of room.
Let it get to the curl. Here goes.
Yep. Here goes. Yep. Nine to go. Hard. Stop it, guys. Stop it.
Hard.
And they're looking at it make the break now.
Go.
Hard.
By the guard, and they'll drag it into the 12 for Shotstone.
Right on the nose. Not too much of a pop. So I'm just thinking here.
Do you want to split them? Is that an option?
No. I like that.
You're going to be sitting.
What do you mean if you cross it?
If you like that better, that's fine.
Okay, I'm just here though, Merck, please.
Putting it out there.
9.5. I don't mind nosing and trying to pop the guard back here. 9.5.
Now, Joanne's thought from the other end is you try to split that stone, and if you
nose.
Do, the stone that you're actually hitting would likely go behind the guard, but I think that Sherry's right. It's a little bit high, and you've been playing this end from the very first stone to be relatively open in that four-foot area for yourself. You can also hit this back and roll that stone that you hit behind the corner guard so you can get there and still remove your opponent's stone.
Great.
Just like that.
Good shot. Very nice, Merck. That was nice weight.
If you clip this one, you might spill this way. It's not bad either.
Yeah, I've only got like three quarters, so I'll probably stick it. It's just
like 10.
I don't know if I can nose it.
Well, no. The only problem with 10 is that if we clip this, it's going into the house, right?
I don't mind normal. I'm just saying I can't see all of it, so I'll probably flip a little to the corner.
That's okay.
Yeah, it's just no good if we don't stick our shooter.
Rather play the run.
We could draw around it too. We could try to nose hit there too, but she's just gonna go around it.
That's either that or we just draw too, I guess.
Yeah, we could draw here now.
Do you want to call time?
I don't hate it.
Okay.
Yeah, timeout.
So we'll wait for Dan Carey to make his way out onto the ice.
Yeah, but then we can freeze to it. But if you don't stick, if you can't stick your shooter, it's useless, and I don't think we can afford to throw.
We can only see about, here, I think.
Yeah, and I think we have to throw normal in case you clip the guard, so I don't think I like
that. I think
you've
got to draw around it.
Yeah, I think so, too.
We got to bury it.
Try to get buried behind this one, even, as much curl as we can.
Yeah, just lock the stuff
yeah.
in there.
Even if it's back tee, she freezes, we freeze. Right. It's not
and
bad.
We draw a play in.
Yeah, we got to try to get all the way over there.
For sure.
I like that better, too.
Yeah.
That's good. You know, I think that sometimes in just knowing that the clock is not running, you can actually discuss things more. It forces a team discussion. And, you know, if Dan hated something about this call, he wouldn't have hesitated to say it. It's not going to work. Their problem with going through the guard is, the two guards, is that you may not stick the shooter, and then you're going to give Sherry an opportunity to get around those two guards even better. So if you're going to give her an opportunity to get around better, why don't you beat her there?
Kathy, as a mother of two great kids, how hard is it to coach your child?
Well, it depends which child I'm coaching. One is not coachable.
I'm not included in this, by the way. Just saying.
It's a, you know what, for Dan Carey, he has to really separate being a dad and being a coach. And sometimes that's very difficult. But I think that because you have to say sometimes to your child, if they're skipping, that you're wrong. And they don't always like to hear that. And there's also a lot more emotion involved than if you're coaching somebody else.
Christy McDonald, nice draw weight. I think you can still see a little bit of it, though, as Sherry puts the broom down.
Great weight.
You like the split? Back line?
What do you guys like?
By that, you can play hack at it.
I don't mind the split. Well, if we hack, if we touch the guard, that's okay too. It opens it up.
If we touch the guards with hack,
if we play back line, is that enough on the yellow?
Probably not, because you're only hitting it. Yeah, you might be able to get it out. Okay, we'll try the back line on that, but if you get the front, that's fine too, Joe.
Okay, back line to hack, yeah.
Good call.
These are very different shots. Initially, they were talking about hack because there's so much finish at the end. You can get back and touch it back, but they keep wanting to look at that top stone and thinking about splitting it in, which is fine, except for it is a very different throw.
Joanne Rizzo with her first here in eight. A huge scrub from the Lees, the front end. They get it by, very nicely done. And they'll lie too.
Well, that's great freshening. You saw the little high five. Way to go us from the two Lees. That was screamed by and brushed by for sure. Going hard. There is no room between this stone and the guard.
Lee Armstrong, Lee Merklinger. A great brush. They've had a very busy game.
Way to go us.
Oh, they could work on the high five there though.
It is a great part of the game. Brushing makes such a good difference to so many things. We always think about the draws, but the hits, we think about Mark and Benny and how well they sweep and how many shots they make for Kevin and have made for Kevin over the years. Huge part of the game.
Got it there. Got a break.
There.
Room.
It's there.
Oh, then.
Close.
Here come.
No room.
Easy.
Close.
No room.
Close.
No.
Close.
No, no bounce.
It's
no.
Bouncing, isn't it?
Christy McDonald looking for the freeze here.
Okay.
Hey. And she will bump that stone. Kathy, it's always a key matchup when you look at the thirds numbers.
Well, it is, and it was going into the game. And Joanne Rizzo, we always knew that there was no problem with the draws, but some great numbers on her hits today. Christy's having a great game, but when your opponent's at 91%, you're troubling a little bit.
Player comparisons brought to you by Capital One. What's in your wallet?
Oh, more weight.
No more.
Same.
Oh,
same
weight.
No. Oh, I just saw that great shot by Joanne. Yeah. Well swept. Trying to make a finesse shot now and get to the inside.
And once again, the Lees are back to work.
Go.
Tap it back, avoid the jam, and a little roll as Madaw lies three.
Afraid to lose it. It just goes so hard.
Now, they were so worried about it curling so much, they could have gotten off it, and then it would definitely get that roll another couple of inches.
I think he got all of it.
Still a very nice shot.
Well, the bounce is right behind it. That's not terrible. Well, I think we try it anyways.
Yeah.
If I could ever get my shooter, like, a hair inside, I mean, she's just going to hit it anyway, but
nose
is pretty close.
Yeah.
10.
You can always make it the other way, too, because she's going to have to hit it.
Huh?
You can always make it the other way, too, because we're going to be out counting the other one.
We're not sticking our shooter if we're making it the other way.
The other way, meaning across the top of the stone that's in the forefoot. But then you can see the angle that she would have to hit that with would be so slight of the top one that she would roll out.
Chelsea Carey with her first here in eight. In a tie game, winner moves on to the semifinal tonight and will face Rachel Holman. A big scrub to get it by that guard. They just get it by. And a very nice shot to get those two red stones going. It is still Madaw, shot stone.
What? Didn't want to.
Well, that curled a lot more than they had anticipated. They were hoping to stay on the other side a little bit and to keep that one that Christy is rolling right behind it, so making this much more difficult for Sherry Madaw.
Like a little bit more than with Hack? Yeah. I think we want to roll fairly big. Okay.
Okay. You do or you don't?
I think we do.
Okay.
I initially just said a nose hit, but then Joe said she can get the double in the roll.
Okay.
So I'm thinking...
Hack weight still?
Yeah.
Hack weight 65.
Okay.
70.
So we want to go your way, Army?
Yeah. Just make sure it goes away.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. On the outside of it, so hack weight.
Kathy, anything less than two this end, a disappointment for Sherry?
Oh, no, I think in a game like we have had today in the eighth end with only one scored, she'd be happy at two. Right now, she certainly still has three on the table.
Sherry Madaw with hammer here in eight, makes the hit, rolls over, and for now lies three.
Just to the inside of nose.
Mm-hmm. If it's over curling, we can make this too. Yeah.
And still hold her to two, right?
Yeah.
Out turn.
Doubles the call.
Kind of wait.
She's probably throwing
eight and a half, eight.
Early. Sorry?
Eight.
Eight, yeah. Seven and a half, eight. Easy peel.
Make the double and try to roll as far as can?
Yeah.
It's been a game of singles thus far.
Just make sure you got the back one.
Yeah.
When you talk about these trials and giving yourself a chance to represent your country, this could be the biggest shot of the week coming up for Chelsea Carey. Her final stone here in eight without hammer, facing three. Would love to make the double.
Back one.
Get rid of two. Yes, she will, and she is shot stone. That's the best she could have done.
Good. That's really all we can do.
All right. Good job.
That's the best we could have done.
Oh, yeah. We couldn't make a roll and make the double.
And now, finally, eighth end for the first time in this game. A chance for the first deuce.
Playing very relaxed so far. It's good to see. That was the best outcome that she could hope for, which was the double and forced Sherry Madaw to have to hit the stick for two and still keep this game well within reach.
Clean, clean, clean.
Final stone on the way from Sherry Madaw. Hit the yellow and stay in the paint. And she will do just that. So we have a two on the board. And momentum and advantage. Sherry Madaw leading 4-2 in this tiebreaker after eight.
I'm going to run to the back. Thanks.
Welcome back to the MTS Center. Twos have been very hard to come by so far in this crucial tiebreaker. And look at Sherry Madaw finally cracks the deuce in eight for a 4-2 lead over Chelsea Carey with just two ends now remaining. And now it's Carey with hammer, and she'll try to do the same and answer back with a two of her own.
Well, well-managed last end. You know, the tendency could be to play the draw on that last stone, and if you make it perfectly, you might steal one. But if you don't, you give up a bundle, and the game is over. So she made the big double, stuck around, forced Sherry Madaw to have to hit it. And now we'll do her best to score two, maybe even generate a three in this ninth end.
Yeah, finish it a little if you can.
Try to steal coming home, or if she winds up blanking, she still will have last draw coming home. Two is well within reach.
To do.
Just a reminder, don't miss the 2-hour season finale of The Amazing Race. It all starts Sunday on CTV. Meantime, for our curlers, the race is to get to Russia and to qualify and represent Canada at the Olympics. On the women's side, Jennifer Jones is into that final, awaiting who will win the semifinal. And the winner of this one, obviously, will go on and take on Rachel Homan tonight on TSN.
I'm sure that neither of these teams are looking that far ahead. It's all about finishing this one off. And then they will look forward to their date with Rachel.
Mine's a little tight. Gotta be even. Right on the Tim Hortons.
Throwing another corner.
Hard.
Trying to split the front of the house. Create opportunities on both sides. And then we'll start to manipulate those stones in the center.
All right.
But that's really not Sherry Madaw's plan.
Lee Merklinger throwing the peel.
Good, very nice.
Put it back.
Right.
She's been through a lot of big games, both at national Scotties level and in Bonspiels. You talked about her being, or feeling, Brian, that she was more prepared than ever.
Line's close.
I asked her before the game, is this the best that you've ever played? And she told me, yes, it is. And I said, why? And she said, because I've worked hard.
Tight.
I've worked very hard at it.
Doesn't need any. Doesn't need any.
It's a simple answer, but it's so hard to get here. And not only that, bring your A game when you do arrive here.
Okay, it's fine.
Nice shot. Oh. Pretty thick. Want to hit and roll on?
Yeah.
No question for Sherry Madaw that is about removing a corner guard. Just took a look at both of them to figure out which one they were going to go after. Feeling that the double, it's a little thick. Don't want to really stick around. Just as soon peel one out.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Off.
Let it work.
Whoa, right off. Close.
No, no.
No. That's up. No, no, no.
No roll.
Say what?
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Okay.
And the shooter will stick around and find that 12 foot as Madaw lies three. Load hammer here in nine.
Just top tee.
There's a little catcher there now for Chelsea's team. They're able to get behind there. It could be even half open, but Sherry Madaw's team may not be able to try to remove it without the risk of jamming onto that stone just rolled there.
Mine's good. Yeah.
Top eight.
Mine's good.
Close.
Top eight. Line's fine. All you.
Top eight, top four. Line's fine.
You got room. You don't have to go for
that's
the line.
That's a girl.
Till the end.
A mile.
Gonna have to go finish it. Yep.
Here it goes.
Yep. Now. Hard now.
Far as it'll go. Far back as it'll go.
Kristen Foster gets
good
partially
shot
behind that guard for third stone.
Okay. Think about board.
Okay, it doesn't go on that back one?
No, we're good.
Okay.
It would take probably about a quarter of a rock to get there. Okay.
Like you'd have to hit it about here for that to jam.
What kind of weight?
I was thinking here.
Board?
Yeah.
Sure.
Okay.
If I clip the front, that's okay.
But exactly. A 10 can work too, because we're going to roll here.
Yeah.
Perfect. What do you like, 10?
I like board.
Okay, board.
Joanne Rizzo trying to drag it by that yellow guard.
Roll it! Right over, right over! Okay, I'm not sure why that went. Okay.
Well, that curled a lot more than they had wanted. It wasn't her weight. She may have got it going out of her hand. And so now for Chelsea needs to start to move those stones on the center line back, not looking for hack weight, just to tap it back.
Right there, I maybe babied it.
Christy McDonald with her first here in 9.
Okay, it's not bad.
Okay. Okay.
Sorry, I thought it was going to curl more than that.
Yeah, no, it's straight there.
Okay.
You want to try and roll here, Joe? No. Want to roll covered? Okay. 10. Right here is perfect.
And the biggest reason they want to roll covered is those two red stones belonging to Sherry Madaw are right behind the tee line now. So there's this wall building up for Chelsea Carey to be able to get stones in front of that are going to make it pretty difficult for the Madaw team to remove.
Got the nose. Yeah, might as well stay on the nose. Okay.
And she will hit it. Right on the nose as Madaw lies 3.
Here.
Okay.
It won't go anywhere.
It jams. Okay.
Even if you're on the nose, okay, it's not bad. If you bury it here, it's not terrible either.
Yeah, I like that, or if it's
right there if you can.
Yeah. So what was that? Was that like 90?
I got 95.
Okay, I thought I gave a little push.
4.
Okay, so 4, 4, 5.
Yeah.
This is out in that spot where the hits are curling, so just stay close to it.
Kathy, I know it can change within one shot or one end, but it really feels like Sherry Madaw's had momentum the entire game. You agree?
Gotta go a bit.
Yeah, you know what? And I'm not sure why necessarily. I think it's been the kind of game that we're watching play out. And with Sherry Madaw having last rock, it's not been any opportunity other than for Sherry Madaw has felt. And maybe that was last end, but this end is far from over. And those stones belonging to Sherry Madaw actually are her worst enemy right now.
And Chelsea Carey with that bump is shot stone. She has the hammer here in 9, down by 2.
Either we go here,
yeah,
or you play the pick so that we're still 1, 2, 3,
mm-hmm.
Right?
Yeah.
But if we roll here, she's got the double.
Mm-hmm.
Do you want to play just the straight pick?
Yeah, she's going to just try and do that again.
That's
but
fine.
The line's tough to get there,
I think
right?
So, yeah. Yeah, and then we have the same. Okay, just firm. Sure.
What about the double to lie 5, Kathy?
Colin, if it's coming up, then we'll try and
or that, or that jam, maybe.
Well, the problem with the double is firm, that if you pick, don't make the double, you leave the shot stone where it is. And with the score being what it is, the most important thing is to remove that shot stone. If it were last rock, no, I still wouldn't do it.
Okay.
It really is about getting rid of that shot stone. And that double's not a gimme by any stretch of the imagination. A very good chance that the second stone that you hit on the center line would go directly back on to the red behind it in either case.
Sherry Madaw with her first here in 9.
No roll, army.
That's actually great in moving that out of there.
Thanks.
Ah.
That's even better.
Yeah, it was just a soft throw.
Well, this is actually, I think, a better throw in my opinion, because you get rid of that stone in the forefoot that Chelsea for sure was going to be drawing against.
Different. Yeah. Again.
Top four?
Yeah. You want to make it even with that other yellow, I guess?
Sorry?
Even with that other yellow, I guess? Or?
Well, yeah, I mean, we're going to leave or something, I think.
Kathy, I guess I use the word momentum to describe the game or Sherry Madaw's team. I just don't sense that Chelsea Carey's team has that electricity or that pep in their step, for the lack of a better word.
It's funny, you know, we commented that last night that some of the games just seemed weird. It's almost, I don't know. And this one is a sudden death. Last night's game was not. It was more about placement, with Brad Jacobs and Kevin Martin, the winner, going on to the final. The loser certainly far from over. This one, it will be over for someone. And I don't know that I agree that they don't have a pep in their step, but I know what you're saying. You don't have that crazy intense feeling that we have seen in some of the games.
Top four. Just bite forefoot.
Need a big finish now at the end. How far can they pull it? Far enough for shot stone buried. Very well done. And further to that point, Kathy, we haven't seen this Chelsea Carey team on the national stage as much as other teams, so maybe it's not fair for me to make that comment, not of seeing them play as much as others.
Well, that's a great shot by Chelsea right here, Brian. Not only does she have great weight, great brushing, good judgment, big finish at the end, completely buried.
That certainly got the crowd's approval here at the MTS Center.
We had to do it that way and just hope.
Yeah.
Well, her hope, you can see that Sherry Madaw, the only way to get to that stone is the run straight back.
I know I brought it up before, but I think the double is there as well, Kathy, no?
Well, the straight back is, you're going to flog that double, are you? The straight back is the shot.
Final stone, Sherry Madaw on the way here in nine. A big scrub the entire way. Run it back, and she sticks it. Very well done. And look at the red stones now facing Chelsea Carey.
Well, that's a fabulous shot for Sherry Madaw. If she doesn't hit that perfectly, there's a chance for the tie to be coming home in that position instead. Great screaming and brushing to lie four. Big draw for Chelsea Carey.
It's easy for me to skip from up here, that's for sure.
Points for beauty.
Oh, goodness, no.
You like a pinch, Morris?
I wouldn't mind it. But.
Yeah, a little more, Kate. Just be safe. It'll get there.
Chelsea Carey from the Fort Rouge Curling Club here in Winnipeg. Final stone here in nine. And this draw to keep her Olympic hopes alive.
Clean. Where is it?
It's there.
Okay, you got me.
Do you need a tip?
Mine's okay.
No, it's okay. Okay.
Mine's okay. Perfect. Touch forefoot. We're fine. Line. Touch forefoot.
Line's perfect.
Touch forefoot. Right to tee. Touch forefoot.
With the pressure on.
Great nerves right there.
Chelsea Carey delivers. What a shot considering the circumstances. She will pick up the single. Sherry Madaw leads 4-3 with hammer after nine.
Yep.
The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by Tim Hortons. Always fresh, always great tasting coffee. It's now time for today's secret word. The secret word is freezer. Go to finaland.ca and enter this word for your chance to win.
Welcome back to the MTS Center, and Kathy, that ninth end so critical when it came down to Skip's throws.
Well, and both Skips made fantastic shots, starting with Sherry Madaw. After a great draw by Chelsea Carey, she plays the run back, nails it perfectly to lie four. And talk about pressure for Chelsea Carey. Not only does she have to navigate through there, she has to find 4 foot in this pressure pack game. A miss here would have ended any chance of an Olympic dream, but great judging, brushing by the sweepers, great throw. This game is still anyone's.
That amazing touch and a great draw to keep her Olympic hopes alive. And that brings us to a very critical 10th end now in this tiebreaker. Winner moves on to the semifinal tonight to take on Rachel Holman here in Winnipeg. Sherry Madaw leads by one. She now has Hammer here in 10, and we all know what's at stake.
Well, they've got one guard up, asking Lindsay now to throw the high guard just over the hog line so there is no double.
Mine should be okay.
It's like lots.
It's there. All there.
It's not bad.
It's probably two.
Whoa, then.
Want to have as much separation as they possibly can.
Oh, there.
Whoa.
Nice
shot. Very nice.
Those aren't easy to throw, Kathy, are they?
They aren't. The long ones are the hardest. In between the twos and the threes
just
are much
more
easier.
Weight, okay, Lee? Got it. You go by, you got the back one.
And so hoping to tick this stone over.
Hair more. Okay, whoa, different.
She can't remove the stone though, right, Kathy?
She cannot. She can move it. She can certainly remove her own.
Yeah.
And she can remove the one in the house because it is not in the free guard zone.
Hard!
By both guards.
That's fine.
And she will come to that rock in the 8 foot and remove it as Madaw lies one.
Well, and for Sherry, the removal of that stone was almost irrelevant. It wasn't a factor in her mind. It was more important to get one of those stones off. And if you look at that stat for Sherry Madaw, if you believe in the odds, it's highly unlikely that she will be stolen against. Only one end in this entire event has been stolen against this team. That is the best in the field.
Hard. Not go all the way.
And we don't have to look too far. Just go back to their last game in the round robin play and the amazing draw that Sherry made with her final stone to make sure she was in this tiebreaker.
Okay. All right. Not going to hurt us, but you can all get all of them. Yeah, or you can just go for those two.
I think the top one.
Yeah.
Try
7-8. Right there.
If you hit that top one just off nose on the decalb side, it can drive it across the line and potentially make contact with the other two. I think one of them might stick around, but you can get rid of a couple.
Yeah.
Lee Merkinger takes her big breath, lets the big weight fly, run it back, and she'll spill the one yellow, moving those stones around up front.
Did
you have a pre-shot routine, Kathy, you stuck to?
Oh, for sure. I think that every curler at a high level does, and it can be completely different for every person. But so important to do that for every single shot, regardless of whether it's a draw or a hit to lie two or a draw to lie three. Very important.
So you took a breath, thought about me, got in the hack, and let her fly?
And missed.
Yes, line.
Really important, and especially now. You know, it's the 10th end. Even if your nerves have not been in play by now, they are now kicking in. The adrenaline is kicking in, and adrenaline makes your leg drive that much stronger. You think you're throwing the same, but you're not. And so if you can stick to everything that got you this far, your odds of being able to deliver and complete the shot much higher.
Some great sweeping from the front end to get that yellow by the guard, but it curled to the point. You can see it now popping out the other side.
Your shooter's just going to stay here, though, right? But that's fine.
We can just take the one. It's just in the 8 foot.
Pardon me?
We can just take the one if you want.
Sure, but if you get both, that's fine, too.
Yeah.
That's the time works.
The most important stone to be gone is that guard. If you get the one in the house, that's fine. But again, it is, you heard Joanne call down, it only is 8 foot. You just want to make sure you have access to it.
Hard.
Okay.
She'll stick the shooter, but does make the double.
Crawl there or what?
And then she's still leaving that guard. That's
just start again.
That's the biggest problem.
Take like this much more ice.
Pretty thin, Joe.
It's thin?
Yeah, very thin. Peel.
One is fine.
Yep.
Is that the same ice you had? I was tight.
Oh, just a minute. Sorry, just a minute. You know what? You might be better off going thick.
Sure.
Because then your just shooter stays there. I think you're better off going thick.
And so for Joanne now, really important to reset when you're almost locked in and ready to go and there's a change of call. It's not a problem. It's not a balk as in baseball. You can do that, but your mindset needs to go back to where it was for the first shot.
And then.
Yeah. Yeah! Hard!
Joanne Rizzo gets them all moving and the red stones, one is kicked.
Yeah, that's okay. Where was
the other red stone is in the forefoot.
Sorry. I don't know why I thought it hit.
Well, they'll have an official look at this because the stones were moving towards the house. Sherry thought it came off the board.
Sorry? You kick it this way, eh?
Yeah, I
totally stopped it with my foot.
They both would have been in the rings, Kathy, I'm sure of it.
Can we replay that, please?
Here we go.
Oh. Okay, watch this one that's coming towards Sherry now.
Right there. That would have definitely been 12 foot, I'm sure.
It looked like it was going this way. That was me.
That was that. Wasn't it on the cop?
It was. She kicked it. It was coming this way.
Yeah, it's coming out the center line, though.
Oh, it was actually going that way.
It was going this way.
It was that way, wasn't it?
No, it was going that way.
That one hit.
There's her foot.
No, it was going that way. Wasn't it?
Yeah. I think that's where it would go.
I thought it was the official.
One more time?
Yeah.
Here we go. It's again.
Here, watch again.
So it started here?
But it's going.
So right there she kicks it. I think it would have been 12 foot, but moving to our right television side.
Where do we think? Yeah. I thought it was getting close to the house. But
I thought it was on the
word. That's where I stopped it.
Yeah, well, that was on the words. Can we see it one more time? Can they stop it where it was?
But go again.
The house,
go again.
What?
It was going
in. One more time.
She kicked it with her foot.
Yeah, that's what Chelsea
thinks
too.
Yeah,
I thought it was
going
to the
house.
It was going in.
Well, I was the offender, so.
That is correct.
Close, I think.
No, I thought it was going.
So that means Chelsea gets to decide, Kathy?
It's up to where she thinks it would have gone.
It wasn't that close to the rings.
It was up higher.
It wasn't.
The rock. It goes back.
You do it.
Well, show it again.
Show it on the screen. It wasn't that close to the rings.
It was up higher.
Not even close.
Watch.
So let's watch closely. Now, Kathy, if you take in momentum.
It's up by the.
It's just by the coffee cup.
It was going on.
No, it would have spun into the rings, I think, in my opinion.
It would have gone close.
It's hard, it's hard because it's in slow motion already. So is it actually slowing down?
But it is hard to know. You have to do your best guess. And I think that both of the teams tried to put it back to the best of their abilities to where it would have been. There's no huge advantage to either team.
Just to clear that thought up, though, Kathy. So if it's Sherry that did the kicking of the stone, Chelsea has final decision on where she thinks it should go.
Yeah, if Sherry had said, no, I really think it needs to go 6 inches to the left, and Chelsea says, no, I think it would have gone 6 inches to the right, that's where it would have gone.
It's okay.
Within reason, obviously.
Well, then.
With that sorted out, we continue here. This 10th end, Mada up 4-3 with Hammer. Chelsea Carey needing to steal.
Is it curling yet? Is it curling yet?
to keep her Olympic hopes alive.
Tight. Finishing really good.
It's just tight.
Whoa then. Whoa. I just don't want to leave her an easy double. Okay.
Oh, we saw freeze.
Just took a little off.
Okay, good sweep.
Right there, Joe, and she got them all. Think you probably need a quarter. Right there.
Which turn am I playing?
You're playing the rad first.
Out turn or in?
You're playing the out.
In?
Did you like that?
Turn?
Yeah. Okay. Then your shooter goes up.
Double check the turn. I didn't hear her.
In turn, right?
What turn? Oh, sorry, out.
Out turn. Oh. Okay.
Well, good thing she checked.
And that's happened once on the men's side.
Lots of time.
We just didn't hear what turn you wanted.
No, I was thinking.
Well, I like the out. You can come take a look.
No, it's fine.
It's all good.
It's got to be on the same page.
Joanne resetting.
Bird.
Yes! Bird.
Oh, you got it!
And they pick her up right out of her hand.
Right up!
The Lees both scrubbing hard.
Fine.
The yellow bounces in to the 12-foot. Kathy, we talked about it. We thought possibly the first deuce wins, and so far Sherry Madoff is certainly in the driver's seat.
Well, it really wasn't until the eighth end that there was the opportunity, and Sherry took full advantage of it. But what a great shot by Chelsea Carey in nine. Facing four, she makes the draw that if she doesn't, the game is over. And look at those numbers. Whoever goes through to play Rachel Holman tonight will be a force to contend with.
The game story brought to you by M&M Meat Shops, frozen food at its best, as another timeout is taken by the Carey team.
Or she might go in there. Like if she goes to the guard, she goes here. Then we've got nothing this way. You have to play like a hit and flop. Yeah. That's true. What do you like, Doug? I'm just worried about going here. It's hard to get to this. I'd love to get there, but I don't think you can.
Yeah, I don't mind coming back to this.
Back to this one? Well, this way.
I'm just worried that it's going to...
With the out turn. Just worried
well,
what?
I just think it's going to curl like crazy.
No, to this one, he's saying.
Oh, you mean, oh, to come around here?
Yeah, like the same shot you're saying, but a little deeper.
Like
back button, so
we
you want to stay shot.
We want to be shot.
You like that?
Yeah, even if
you stop it on the tee line, it's not terrible. She makes the double, she should hopefully leave her shooter
I think
shooter
you want to bring it back, and then she's going to try to do something with it.
And it
might
so
leave
good
a rock
there
for you to come down
to. Here,
to
here.
Anywhere around there. I think you got to try to... Wire went in there. I don't like hitting.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
No, I wasn't talking about hitting. I was talking about just tapping and sitting like it's
yeah,
sort of in front
I think
of
you got them. A good setup here. I think
yeah,
you got to
okay.
go around there.
I don't mind that.
Okay, so we got to take
we were taken there for
it's
the guards.
Like
that you got to, yeah.
So.
If the weight's there, it should hold longer, though. We've been a little light on everything.
Yeah.
Well, hoping that it's going to move this way. Oh, my goodness, with three stones, nonetheless.
Okay, Ron Burgundy. Get it together over
back
there.
Button.
Even if they're back here, they know that Sherry's going to have to play a hit. She's going to move those stones around, and in the process of doing that, maybe they create a situation that's even better for them than they currently are.
Two lines okay, but
same as you're throwing. It's good.
It's not any slower?
I don't think so. 95-4, like you've been throwing, is good.
Well, some great numbers, and no bigger draw than the last end.
Chelsea Carey with her
Line
first
room.
Here in a crucial 10th end.
Let it get to the curl.
It'll curl. Gotta be T.
Gonna have to go for weight.
Make sure it's T line. That's fine. It's gonna finish. Make sure it's T. Full line.
It's okay. No line.
I know, but gotta go for
weight. Yep. Hard. Hard. Hard.
Not able to bury, but they drag it in for a second shot.
Well, it's really tough as a mom, for sure, watching.
Well, I wasn't saying
hard enough watching
saying,
your husband and a briar and a world's, but it's probably much worse watching your daughter. Proud, and yet wanting everything good.
Guys, like that?
Is that so she doesn't have the tap, or do you like the nose?
Unless you like the if we out. Get the roll, she can't tap, Joe.
I know, but then she comes around to here if we get the roll.
What's wrong with nose?
The nose?
Right, she hits it, she's
yeah.
not shot.
Okay. So just a tan nose.
Yep.
I
like it.
Yep, me too.
You've got lots of air too.
Yeah, and we played this in the eighth end, right?
Yeah, you like that?
Yep.
For sure, Madonna needs to get rid of that stone, and they believe if they hit and stick right there, it takes away the draw from that side. With the long guard on the right-hand side of the center line, the other side of the sheet is shut down. Would force Chelsea to play something more than like a back line, boardish weight through the hole. You can see Chelsea already thinking about her options if this shot is made.
Yeah, that's what I mean. I think those are the two options. It's either the hit and roll or the tap.
And you just heard her comments there, Sherry Madaw.
Win it.
Yeah.
Has a 1-point lead, has the hammer here in 10, her first. Wants to hit and stick. Great scubbing from the leaves there, and they'll roll it in. So Madaw lies 2 in the forefoot.
Thanks.
Shot.
I like that too.
Yeah, I think you want to be just shot.
You want to be just shot, yeah.
Because if you're back here, she just hammers this one, although it's not the easiest hole, but it's there pretty easily. If we're right there, she can't really.
Yep.
Just bite the button.
Yep.
Do I need less ice?
Maybe just a hair.
Yeah, I had here.
I wouldn't take a ton.
So yeah. Here.
Okay.
Well, nice roll by Sherry Madaw, but the only reason they didn't want the roll is it opens up this path for Chelsea Carey.
Back button?
Top button. Make sure we're shot. Like, if it slides to the T-line, at least we make her make something, but she just hammers that one anywhere and it goes, right? Mm-hmm.
So, where's the perfect spot?
The perfect spot is top button.
Okay.
But we have to be shot. Yeah. So make sure we're buttoned somewhere.
The good news too though, Kathy, for Sherry, she has
a little more weight, or can
that redstone
I got like
in the forefoot that she could also like run back, the short run back as well, true?
She does. Be tricky though, you have to come past that stone that is at the top of the house to do it.
Final stone here in 10 for Chelsea Carey. You see those 2 in the forefoot.
Good.
Sherry's lying 3 overall.
Okay. Top button. Mine's good. Starting to curl a bit now.
She had a big draw at 9. Needs another big one here in 10.
Fine. Top button.
Gotta
top
be there.
Button. Mine's fine. We got room.
Whoa, whoa, whoa.
Top button.
It's okay.
Whoa. Top button. Cool. Yep.
Needs to finish. Got to drag it now for shot stone. And they put it right on the button to lie 1 here in 10.
That's great emotion. Brad Jacobs, meet Mary Carey. That's a great shot. Great judgment by the brushers. You have to wait as long as you can. There's that curl, that huge finish that you get at the end. Absolutely perfect weight.
Back-to-back ends with fantastic draw weight.
I was thinking a 9, Joe.
And there's that redstone, Kathy, I talked about.
Yeah.
Well, for Chelsea Carey, she wanted to initially be maybe a couple of inches higher so that this shot wasn't so automatic. But these are the shots that you want to force your opponent to make. You want them to throw the last rock and make a precision shot.
Carey's done all she can, and now she can only look on. Both these teams came in with 4-3 records. They met in the final game of round robin play. That set up this tiebreaker. Final stone here for Sherry Madaw. A chance to go to the semifinals tonight against Rachel Homan.
Great shot, Sherry.
Very nice.
Sherry Madaw is going to the semifinals. And now Manitoba's hopes rest on Jennifer Jones. And finally, smiles of relief after a very close game. 6-3 your final score. Sherry Madaw winning this tiebreaker. And maybe the emotion hitting Chelsea Carey now as she salutes the fans. It was a great week, a great battle back week for Chelsea Carey and her team. High five from Dad and a nice hug. She did her best on home ice. But sadly for her, her Olympic dreams come to an end. Here is now the situation. We talked about Jennifer Jones. She is Manitoba's hope. She is into that championship final on Saturday. Tonight, Sherry Madda with that win will take on Rachel Holman right here on TSN, 7:30 p.m. Eastern time. And of course, Madda knows his team very well, as she was their fifth in PEI back at the Scotties. It's been a great week of action.
The 2013 Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings is brought to you by Ford, proud partner of the Canadian Curling Association for 20 years, by Scotties Facial Tissue, Scotties, the perfect touch, and by World Financial Group, creating a better tomorrow for families today. WFG.
What a great feeling for Sherry Madda and her team as they get the job done. And for Chelsea Carey, a disappointing week, but a great salute to the fans. It sets up a very exciting final weekend here in Winnipeg. The Tim Hortons Roar of the Rings. Two teams will represent Canada and be off to the Olympics in Russia. We're back tonight with the semifinal. On behalf of myself and Kathy Gauthier, thank you for watching TSN. We'll see you tonight.